National Hockey League is proud to bring you this special presentation. Shining brightly across the National Hockey League this season. In Edmonton, Wayne Gretzky's brilliance is once again incomparable. The Great One is heading for his sixth consecutive scoring title with a chance to break his records for assists and points. Sparkling right beside him is defenseman Paul Coffey, last year's Norris Trophy winner, whose offensive power ranks him alongside the great Bobby Orr. In Chicago, there's a star glowing. It belongs to the spectacular Dennis Savard. The 24-year-old center is an all-star for the fourth time and is having his best year ever. Illuminating the city of Pittsburgh is the rising star named Mario Lemieux. He was the MVP of the All-Star game last year. This year, his dominance on the ice is being compared to Gretzky. In Philadelphia, there shines a big star whose forte is scoring goals. Big Tim Kerr is tied for the league lead. The brightest stars in hockey will be shining in Hartford for the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game tonight. Live from the sold-out Civic Center in Hartford, the great capital of the great state of Connecticut, it's the 38th annual All-Star Game on ESPN. Heroes, hoopla, and hype. And lots more as the city of Hartford is hosting Hockey Night in North America. Hi again, everybody. I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome to a very special night on ESPN. Special coverage, lots of innovations in hockey coverage that you've never seen before. We've got our expert play-by-play man, Sam Rosen, standing by, and our expert analysts, Mickey Redman and John Davidson, too. Roaming the stands and covering the celebrities and dignitaries who are all here is Tom Meese. And we'll have special features between all of the intermissions. It's a special night. The city of Hartford is alive. You can't buy a ticket to this All-Star game. Those tickets have been gone for months. And, of course, the banquet last night, some of which you will see a little bit later, sold out, over 1,500 in attendance. Souvenir vendors, well, they're selling T-shirts faster than they can print them. It's a special night, the 38th All-Star game, live on ESPN. From Hartford, Connecticut, the 38th NHL All-Star Game on ESPN. Brought to you by Konica Copiers, the tough copiers for tough customers nationwide. We'll be right back with a starting lineup right after these messages.
Converse leather basketball shoes free when you buy 10 rolls or more of any Owens Corning Pink insulation. So insulate now and save on your heating bills.
Good evening, hockey fans in Hartford and across North America. Welcome to the 38th annual All-Star Game. I'd like to introduce to you now the members of the Campbell Conference Squad as selected by you, the fans. First, from the Calgary Flames, their fine young rookie defenseman, number 21. From the Chicago Blackhawks, one of the National Hockey League's most exciting players, appearing in his fourth All-Star contest, number 19, Dennis Savard. From the Detroit Red Wings, their offensive catalyst, playing in his fifth All-Star game, number 25, welcome left winger John Ogrodnik. And from the Edmonton Oilers, their veteran defenseman, playing in his first All-Star game, number 2, Lee Fogelin. another of the Oilers' top defensemen, playing in his third All-Star game, number 4, Kevin Lowe. Making his fourth All-Star appearance, the Oilers' outstanding and versatile forward, former winner of the Conn Smythe Trophy for 1984, the Stanley Cup Most Valuable Player, number 11, Mark Messier. Playing in his second All-Star game, one of the Oilers' two fine All-Star goaltenders, number 35, Andy Moog. From the Los Angeles Kings, their captain, this will be his third All-Star contest, their high-scoring right winger, number 18, Dave Taylor. From the Minnesota North Stars, their top center, playing in his second All-Star contest, a member of the 1980 U.S. Olympic gold medal winning hockey team, number 12, Neil Broughton. From the St. Louis Blues, their leading goal scorer and fine all-round player, number 20, Mark Hunter. Also from the St. Louis Blues, making his third NHL All-Star appearance, their leading defenseman, number 5, Rob Ramage. And from the Toronto Maple Leafs, last year's top draft choice, rookie left winger, number 15, Wendell Clark. From the Vancouver Canucks, playing in his first All-Star game, their fine right winger, number 14, Tony Tanti. And from the Winnipeg Jets, their captain and scoring center, making his third All-Star appearance, the 1982 Calder Trophy winner for the NHL Rookie of the Year, number 10, Dale Hawerchuk. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the starting lineup for the Campbell Conference as selected by the hockey fans across North America in the NHL's first ever All-Star fan balloting. In goal from the Edmonton Oilers, the backstop of their two consecutive Stanley Cup championships, recognized as one of the game's leading goaltenders. He's playing in his fourth All-Star game, number 31, Grant Fuhr. On defense, also from the Edmonton Oilers, last year's Norris Trophy winner, is the top NHL defenseman. He received more fan votes than any other player. His fifth NHL All-Star appearance, number 7, Paul Coffey. On defense, from the Chicago Blackhawks, playing in his fifth NHL All-Star game, their hard-shooting former Norris Trophy winner, number 24, Doug Wilson. Wing, again from the Oilers of Edmonton. He combines blinding speed with great hustle. He's playing in his third All-Star game. Here's number 9, Glenn Anderson. On right wing, making his fourth All-Star appearance, last year's Lady Byng Trophy winner for his combination of excellence and sportsmanship. Again from the Edmonton Oilers, number 17, Yari Curry. Conference center, the 1980 Lady Byng Trophy winner, the 1983 All-Star Game MVP, the 1985 Stanley Cup Playoff MVP, six-time winner of the Hart Trophy, the captain of the Edmonton Oilers, number 99, Wayne Gretzky. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the coach of the Clarence Campbell Conference. He has led his team to the Stanley Cup Finals for the past three seasons and captured the cup in the last two. He was also the coach of Team Canada in 1984, Glenn Sather. His assistant, Jack Riley, longtime hockey coach of the United States Military Academy at West Point, and last night's recipient of the Lester Patrick Award. The trainers for the Campbell Conference, from the Chicago Blackhawks, Lou Varga, and from the Winnipeg Jets, Chuck Babcock. Ladies and gentlemen, the honorary captain of the Campbell Conference, this Hall of Fame center played in 10 NHL All-Star games between 1969 and 1980, twice a winner of the Hart Trophy as the NHL's most valuable player, hockey's second all-time leading scorer, Phil Esposito. Now, ladies and gentlemen, to introduce to you the Wales Conference All-Stars, the voice of the Hartford Whalers for the last 7 years, here is Chuck Caton. Thank you very much, Jim. And now, my pleasure to present to you the members of the Prince of Wales All-Star Squad. From the Buffalo Sabres, their reliable defenseman playing in his fourth All-Star game, the Sabres' top plus-minus player for two of the last 3 years, number six, Mike Ramsey. From the hometown Hartford Whalers, their captain, who's unable to play due to injury, the Whalers' 1985 All-Star representative, Ron Francis. His replacement making his first All-Star appearance, the Whalers' very fine left wing, number 15, Sylvie Turgeon. From the Montreal Canadiens, their offensive spark plug playing in his second All-Star game, number 27, Mats Näslund. Also from the Montreal Canadiens, their top-notch defenseman, a two-time Norris Trophy winner and 1978 playoff MVP, playing in his seventh All-Star game and on-ice captain tonight, number 19, Larry Robinson. From the New Jersey Devils, their fine young hard-working forward who's been an All-Star in each of his first two NHL seasons, number 9, Kirk Muller. From the New York Islanders, their high-scoring, sharp-shooting right wing, playing in his seventh All-Star game. He's never failed to score 50 goals in a season, a former Rookie of the Year, Lady Bing winner, All-Star and playoff MVP, number 22, Mike Bossy. One of the best all-around players in hockey, a former Rookie of the Year, leading scorer, playoff MVP, and Hart Trophy winner, appearing in his seventh All-Star contest, from the Islanders, number 61, Brian Trotche. From the New York Rangers, their super skating defenseman, making his All-Star debut, number 29, Rayo Ruotsalainen. From the Philadelphia Flyers, their league-leading goaltender, playing in his first All-Star game, number 35, Bob Froese. Now here's the Flyers' fine all-around defenseman, having a super season, playing in his third All-Star game, number 2, Mark Howe.
Also from Philadelphia, their captain and inspirational on-ice leader, playing in his first All-Star contest, number 20, Dave Poulin. Making his third All-Star appearance, here's the Flyers' consistently high-scoring left wing, number 26, Brian Propp. From the Quebec Nordiques, their captain and all-time leading scorer, playing in his fifth All-Star game, a former Rookie of the Year, number 25, Peter Stastny. From the Washington Capitals, making his third All-Star appearance, their great offensive gunner, number 11, Mike Gartner. By the ballots of North America's hockey fans, the Prince of Wales Conference starters. In goal from the Quebec Nordique, former star of the Canadian Olympic team and the backstop in the Nordique playoff drive last year, making his All-Star debut, number 33, Mario Gosselin. On defense from the Boston Bruins, their co-captain and one of the most complete blue liners in hockey today, a former Calder winner as NHL Rookie of the Year. He's played in the All-Star game in six of his seven NHL seasons, number 7, Ray Bourque. Also on defense from the Washington Capitals, their team captain and leader, a two-time Norris Trophy winner, making his sixth All-Star appearance, number 5, Rod Langway. At left wing from the Quebec Nordiques, their super scorer who has notched 50 goals in each of the last three seasons and is on his way to a fourth, playing in his fourth All-Star game, number 16, Michel Goulet. From the Philadelphia Flyers, their big offensive machine with the golden touch on the power play, playing his third All-Star contest, number 12, Tim Kerr. And at center, from the Pittsburgh Penguins, the MVP of last year's All-Star game in Calgary, last year's Calder Trophy winner as NHL Rookie of the Year, playing in his second All-Star game, number 66, Mario Lemieux. The coach of the Prince of Wales Conference in his first NHL season last year, he led the Philadelphia Flyers to the league's best regular season record and to the Stanley Cup Finals, and was awarded the Jack Adams Trophy as the NHL's Coach of the Year, Mike Keenan. His assistant coach from the Philadelphia Flyers, E.J. McGuire. The trainers for the Wales Conference, from the Hartford Whalers, their head trainer, 19-year veteran, Tommy Woodcock. And also from the Whalers, their assistant trainer, 14-year veteran, Skip Cunningham. Ladies and gentlemen, recently, the world of hockey was saddened by the death of an all-star, Philadelphia Flyers goaltender Pelle Lindbergh. And the entire world mourned the loss as well of seven brave astronauts who gave their lives in the pursuit of the exploration of outer space. We ask that you now observe a moment of silence in tribute to Pelle Lindbergh and to the crew of the space shuttle Challenger 10. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we honor the two great nations of the National Hockey League.
And welcome back to ESPN's 38th All-Star Game. We've got a great game coming up. We will, of course, be going to Sam Rosen and, of course, our expert analyst, John Davidson, and Mickey Redman. And Tom Meese is roving the stands with celebrities and dignitaries. The governor is here, along with Alan Thicke and a host of others. But right now, let's go back to the ice, and here is the Canadian national anthem.
True patriot love in all thy sons come. The true north, strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. Stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Now, once again, here is the Coast Guard Academy Glee Club to sing the national anthem of the United States.
It's the 38th All-Star Game, live on ESPN. We've had the introductions of the starting lineups, and we've met the All-Stars. We'll drop the puck and meet the honorary captains, Phil Esposito and Gordie Howe, after this timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, the ceremonially begin the 38th NHL
Explore Texas. It's the finest place to go. Explore Texas. There's some real good friends to know. Explore Texas. There's so many fun things to do. And Texas is waiting for you.
You know, when Dennis Hall broke into the National Hockey League, Dennis, of course, the brother of Bobby, and played his first game against Gordie Howe, Gordie picked him up by the seat of his pants and said, "Young man, where do you think you're going?" Dennis said, "Anywhere you want to, sir." Well, Phil Esposito and Gordie Howe had many great face-offs, and they reflected back.
He was my idol. I loved him. I idolized him. First game in the league, his sharp elbows gave it to me. What can you say? He was the dirtiest.
You're welcome, Phil. I think it really did make you a better-looking individual, that little tap on the beak. But as a garbage picker, I think you're the greatest.
There are two honorary captains, and now we are getting set for what will be a very special moment here. You can see Gordie Howe shaking hands with Wayne Gretzky, Larry Robinson, and Phil Esposito in the center. And it is the ceremonial face-off taking place. The president of the National Hockey League, Mr. John Ziegler, is out at center ice, along with a young man who captured the hearts of America. He was born on June 28, 1962. He took 8.5 months to run across the country on just one leg. His idol was Terry Puck. Jeff Keith was the young man who dropped the puck in the ceremonial face-off. So we are just about set for the All-Star Game. Let's go upstairs now to Sam Rosen.
Thank you, Jim. My pleasure to be working with two former fine NHL players, Mickey Redmond, who appeared in the National Hockey League All-Star Game, and John Davidson, who went to a lot of All-Star Games. And Mickey, how about the feeling of the players coming into tonight's game?
Well, Sam, I think the players themselves like to have a little bit of fun with this game. They come out here, they get in that dressing room with the great players around the league. They have a lot of laughs, and they get together. It's a little bit of a break for them. I think the important thing for them is they would like to impress the other players in that hockey club, make that perfect pass back and forth, and really put on a show. And, of course, you get the car at stake for the player that comes out on top.
But once the game starts, I really believe that, you know, the competitiveness of the players sets in. They really want to win.
Oh, there's no question about it. They certainly want to win the hockey game. It's an ego thing. I mean, they don't want the, and they're bragging rights. They do not want to lose the hockey game. I don't think you'll see a lot of physical activity. We normally don't, but you never know in an All-Star game. It's just a lot of great talent being displayed.
And John Davidson, it must be a tough one for the goaltenders.
I think so. When you actually look at that Campbell team, they have 9 Edmonton Oilers there. Mario Gosselin and Bob Froese may have a tough time because those guys are used to playing with each other. They may make some pretty plays. Wayne Gretzky, he's always good.
Should be a shooter's game, a lot of skating and a lot of fun. Right now, roving the stands and filling us in on the dignitaries who are at tonight's game, Tom Mees. Let's go to him right now.
Thank you very much, Sam Rosen. My job tonight, well, it'll be an interesting one. I'm going to rove the highways and byways of this Hartford Civic Center in Hartford, Connecticut. Going to talk to some of the interesting people, and there are plenty of them here tonight watching this All-Star game. And also between periods, I'll be talking to Hall of Famers like, well, Gordie Howe and Phil Esposito. Those are just two names to wet your whistle. So lots coming up from on the ice and also around the Hartford Civic Center tonight. Right now, it's time to go watch the All-Star game. I got my program. I'm all set. Let's go to Jim Kelly. Jim?
All right, Tom, get some soda and beer. We'll be coming right back with the starting face-off. It's the 38th All-Star game live on ESPN. So stay with us. Some special innovations. You'll see camera coverage you've never seen before. All-Star Game live on ESPN is brought to you by Plymouth, a division of Chrysler Corporation. Plymouth, the pride is back. And by Wheaties. Full tilt, all-out good whole wheat. Wheaties, what the big boys eat.
Set for the action. The Wales Conference All-Stars wearing the white jerseys, and in the orange jerseys, the Campbell Conference All-Stars. The West, if you will, in the orange, and the East in the white uniforms. Tonight's officials Ron Wicks is the referee. This is his second All-Star game. He is the senior referee in the National Hockey League. The linesman, John D'Amico, his 16th All-Star game. Gord Brossaker is in his first All-Star game as a linesman. The starting goaltenders on the right, number 33, Mario Gosselin of the Quebec Nordiques. On the left, Grant Fuhr of the Edmonton Oilers. What type of goaltender today, John?
Grant Fuhr is more of a reflex goaltender, Sam. Mario Gosselin really is a good reflex goaltender himself. I think you'll see Fuhr actually stand up a little more so than Gosselin, but Fuhr is looking a little bit nervous during all the proceedings. He was bouncing back and forth, and you can see how his concentration is going already. You see the difference in masks they use there. Grant Fuhr has gone away from a pure fiberglass mask. He's now wearing partial fiberglass, partial screen. He's been hit a couple of times up high this season, and a full cage there for Mario Gosselin.
Lemieux and Gretzky on the draw, and Ray Bourque of Boston has the puck over to Michel Goulet. Kerr with a quick snapshot that's knocked down by Fuhr, and Gretzky sends it ahead to Glenn Anderson. Anderson tied for the league leading goals at the All-Star break. Then Campbell Conference All-Stars are offside. Curry offside on the play. There's Glenn Anderson having an outstanding year as he is really putting the puck away beautifully.
Well, Anderson is up there, Sam, in the scoring after also missing a half a dozen games of the suspension. John, you talked about the nervousness of the goaltenders. I suppose they'd have a reason to get nervous when you look at some of the shooters that are out here tonight.
Just look at that one line, Curry, Anderson, and Gretzky. I can understand Mario Gosselin being a little bit nervous, especially since he's in his first game in the All-Star balloting.
Doug Wilson, who had been playing with a helmet, doesn't have the helmet on tonight. For the All-Stars, this is Anderson having it knocked away by Ray Bourque. Anderson again dropping it to Doug Wilson of the Chicago Blackhawks. Now it's Jari Kurri. And here comes Coffey. Meets Langway, holds up, throws it across. It's knocked down by Bourque. And back come the Wales Conference All-Stars, who won last year in Calgary 6-4. Led by Mario Lemieux, who had two goals and an assist. Back behind the net, Kerr steering it out front. Lemieux sends it through. Picked up off the boards by Kirk Muller, number 9 of the New Jersey Devils. Trying to get it out front. He was checked behind there by Coffey. Muller centers for Kerr. It's off his stick. And Coffey knocks it away from Lemieux. Out in center ice. Anderson is tied up. Lemieux knocking it ahead. That's Muller with the puck on a 2-on-1. Trying to get it across. He shoots and it's a save off the stick of Fuhr while he was down on the ice. This is Mark Hunter of the St. Louis Blues, number 20, sending it in. Knocked away by Gosselin out of the zone. And Lee Fogelin, playing in his first National Hockey League All-Star game, drives it around. Gosselin stops the puck. Larry Robinson, the captain of the Wales Conference All-Stars. That puck deflected in front. Here's Hunter with a shot deflected off Mark Howe. Bossy has the puck and sends it around to Larry Robinson, who's really having a great year, Mickey. To be getting better this season.
Well, Robinson had a couple of off years for Larry Robinson, Sam, but he is back leading that hockey club, as we've seen him do in the past, the veteran hockey player. He's really quite a stabling force, not only in the defense, but that whole Montreal hockey club.
Here's Robinson with the puck, sending it up the middle, and out come the Wales Conference All-Stars. Bossy has it. Looking around, goes back to the defense. Rayo Ruotsalainen of the New York Rangers in his first All-Star game. On the left wing and across they come. It's centered in front for Poulin. Naslund setting him up. It's a 2-on-2 down. Messier across against Ruotsalainen. Trying to center, who's blocked. Messier checked by Ramsey. Poulin picks up the puck. Now it's Brian Frot, number 26. And across the line comes Mats Naslund. Naslund trying to cut inside. And Gary Suter took the puck away. Gary Suter of the Calgary Flames in his first All-Star game. Ruotsalainen deflecting the puck, and it's offside. 17:04 to go in this first period. There is no score in the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game. Gordie Howe, the National Hockey League's all-time scoring leader and leader in all-star appearances. It was 1980 in Detroit, where Gordie Howe, at the age of 51, played in his 23rd NHL All-Star game. The crowd of 20,000 at Joe Louis Arena gave their hero a standing ovation, and Gordie didn't disappoint them in the game. He assisted on a goal by Réal Cloutier as the Wales Conference beat the Campbell 6-3. Gordie Howe, an NHL All-Star moment to remember.
And John Davidson, Mickey Redmond, Jim Kelly, and Tom Meese here at the Hartford Civic Center for the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game.
Sam, interesting to look down at the ice right now. Two number sevens, Coffey and Bork, opposing each other. Of course, a lot of talk. Who should be the Norris Trophy winner each year? Who is the better of the two? Let's watch them against each other.
That shot by Bork deflects up into the stands. How about Mark Howe? He's not too bad either.
Oh, boy. Rod Langway goes on and on and on, but I just like watching the two sevens go against each other.
You know, you talk about those two number sevens. They were the leading vote getters by the fans and were rewarded with trophies yesterday at the health center here in the Hartford area. Paul Coffey and Raymond Bork.
That's set up off the stick of Peter Stastny. Stastny looking for the puck. It's knocked away and cleared out of the zone. Neil Broughton wearing number 12. It's deflected off of him. A couple of the players not wearing their normal uniform numbers. That is because seniority rules here. Dave Taylor of the L.A. Kings sending it across, just missed on the far side. And back come the Wales Conference All-Stars. Bork leading the rush on a three-on-one. That shot by Howe goes wide. A good chance there. If Peter Stastny behind, centering it, just missed and out of the zone. Howe recovers. Sent back in. Stopped by Grant Fuhr for Doug Wilson, former Norris Trophy winner of the Chicago Blackhawks. Doug Wilson, who one season scored 39 goals. Across the line come the Campbell All-Stars. Curry leaves it in the corner, where the Wales Conference picking it up and coming out of the zone. Lemieux carries the puck, chased by Gretzky. Lemieux is in, and it's knocked away by Gretzky to Anderson.
Nice move by Big Mario.
Curry sending it in. That's an interesting matchup. Lemieux and Gretzky.
And of course, we spoke earlier about the comparisons between Lemieux and Gretzky. And of course, Lemieux off to another great start after last year's 100-point Rookie of the Year season.
Kerr going across, it's thrown into the corner. And played around the boards by Goulet. Trying to come out in front was Curry. Checked by Kevin Lowe. Fogelin is on Goulet in the corner. Fuhr knocking it away. And Kevin Lowe, the fine defenseman of the Edmonton Oilers, number four, fires it out of the zone. Yari Curry. Curry comes across with Gretzky. Gretzky sends it across, and Anderson is stopped by Gosselin.
What a pass by Wayne Gretzky. He feathers the puck over top of the defender's stick right onto Glenn Anderson's blade, and he takes a shot quickly. Mario Gosselin, his first shot he's had to handle this game, he got across quickly. Watch Gretzky wait. He passes from his forehand, and he feathers it. Look at over top of the blade of Robertson's stick right onto Glenn Anderson's stick. In one motion, he shot it. And Mario Gosselin got across quickly. And that's the style you'll see from Mario Gosselin. He's one of those acrobatic type of goaltenders. Look how Gretzky could just put that pass perfectly. What a save that was.
Of course, the Oilers have such an advantage when they play together. Anderson, Gretzky, and Curry, that's their normal line during the season. So they know where each other's going to be a little better than some of the guys on different squads.
There's the line in sending it back, and it's sent out of the zone where the Campbell All-Stars and the Irons break it up. Dale Howardchuk of the Winnipeg Jets sending it back. Now it's Gary Suter, who played at the University of Wisconsin for a couple of years, sending it in, and Kirk Muller, second-year wing of the New Jersey Devils, sending it to Mike Fosse. Fosse, seven-time All-Star, is tied up in center ice, and the puck taken away by Mark Hunter. Hunter having an outstanding year for the St. Louis Blues with 30 goals this season. Ramsey, wearing number six tonight, is checked in the corner by Hunter. In comes Fosse looking for the puck. Still loose, and the whistle blows. With 14-12 to go in the first period, there is no score in the game. As you look at Mike Fosse, who has really exploded, and the Islanders have been red hot of late. Fosse with 38 goals this season.
Now, Mike Fosse is an interesting story, Sam. Of course, he makes a lot of money with the good years he's had. But he travels on the road, and he studies financial business. And he handles his own business affairs, really aware of personal life. Mike Fosse does a good job in all aspects. He certainly does a job on the ice.
Mike Fosse with 8 straight years over 50 goals, 4 times over 60. He's been a consistent superstar in this game.
And his teammate Brian Trotche, wearing number 61 tonight, sends it in.
Robinson is wearing Trottier's usual number of 19. Kirk Muller is on the left wing with a back pass to Langway, who shoots it wide. That's Mark Messier, number 11, with the puck. Messier carrying down. It comes across the line. Drop for Tanti is broken up and cleared out of the zone. A little over 6 minutes gone by in the first period of the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game. There's no score. Messier, that's the between the legs of Coffey. And Doug Wilson of the Blackhawks has the puck. Sent ahead by Coffey. Now Tanti comes across the line. Tanti is tied up. In the corner, that's Messier. Overcomes Savard wearing number 19. It's knocked away from him. Tanti wearing number 14. Normally wears number 9. And back come the Wales Conference on a 3-on-2. Poulin with a drop. Save off the shot by Naslin. Puck banned on that shot. And Messier picks up the puck.
Sam, that's the type of play you want to see. A 3-on-2. Lots of passes.
Kept in. Centered off the skate. Robinson centering it back. This is Markow shooting toward the net. It's blocked by Tony Tanti, who sends it around. Naslin keeping it in the zone. And Messier trying to clear it out, and does. Peter Stastny of the Nordiques plays it back to Larry Robinson. Here's Naslin across the line, trying to put it in front. Doug Wilson intercepting.
As you can see, not much hitting it in this game. We're not going to see much of that. I think it's just a showcase of the shooting, passing, skating talents, and a little of the goaltenders too, right, John?
I think we've seen a lot of stuff already. If you want to really talk about skills, 3-on-2s, 2-on-1s, there's been some good plays.
And across the line come the Campbell All-Stars as it's sent through into the corner, intended for Ogrodnik. Savard is there. His pass is stopped by Larry Robinson. Gosselin leaves it for Markow. Turgeon sending it out to Peter Stastny. Stastny across the line with Mike Gartner. The drop is behind Gartner. And back come the Campbell Conference All-Stars. Neil Broughton wearing number 12. Broughton of the Minnesota North Stars. Ruotsalainen knocks the puck away. Along the boards. They look for it. It's worked free by Sylvain Turgeon of the Hartford Whalers. He overskates the puck in center. Turgeon might be a little nervous in his first All-Star game. Ruotsalainen takes the puck away. What a tremendous ovation for Ron Francis, the center of the Hartford Whalers, who's out injured, was supposed to play the All-Star game.
I think fans realize who the heart and soul of the Hartford Whalers is.
Across the line they come. This is Michel Goulet dropping it for Lemieux. Lemieux is tied up along the boards, works his way free. Lemieux still controls the puck with that great reach, great size. Still has the puck. He's hooked by Gretzky. He's tied up along the boards by Suter. And Lemieux still trying to work his way free. The penalty is called. Gary Suter just had too much to handle with Mario Lemieux. 11:09 to go. First period. Power play coming up for the Wales Conference All-Stars. There's no score. Holding.
Chrysler LeBaron GTS challenges BMW 520 AE and Mercedes 190E to a test of performance. Overall, America's GTS dominates the legendary Germans and is under $12,000. LeBaron GTS, we built an American hero.
Now, Chrysler offers you 8.6 financing or up to $1,000 cash back.
Gary Suter gets 2 minutes for holding at 8:51.
John, that's what makes Mario Lemieux so valuable. It's that size and strength. He almost had that thing on a string for about 35 seconds, and they just forced him to keep after him and pull him down.
What was interesting is Lemieux used his body to shield the people away from him and then used the long reach to control the puck. And finally, Suter just wraps his arms around him and tried to throw him down to the ice, and that was a tough task.
First power play opportunity of the game. Doug Wilson has the puck for the Campbell All-Stars and clears it out. I guess Doug Wilson not wearing the helmet tonight indicates he doesn't feel there'll be any rough stuff.
You count the All-Star games in one hand, where you've had any confrontations.
Here's Lemieux. Years. Now to Goulet. Goulet coming in. The back pass and the shot goes wide by Bourque. Robinson has the puck. Robinson gets it ahead to Lemieux. Kerr and Goulet are up front. Goulet is at the right side of the net. Kerr is in the circle to the left. Lemieux has the puck, trying to get it to Kerr. It's intercepted by Yari Curry. Puck picked up by Lemieux, feeds Tim Kerr. Goulet is open. Goulet comes in and shoots. Saved by Fiorini. Covers the nose. Oh, the rebound knocked away. Picked up by Kerr with a back pass to Bourque. And now to Robinson. For Lemieux. Knocked away by Fuhr. Gets it to Kerr, and again, Fuhr anticipating, knocked it away with a right glove.
And that's where Tim Kerr loves to stand. He stands there and waits. You can't move Tim Kerr when you weigh 220 pounds. Grant Fuhr has great movement in that goal crease area. And Kerr, do you see how quick his hands were, Mickey, when he got control of the puck and released it?
For a big man, Timmy Kerr, 6'3", 225 pounds, he has got the softest pair of hands in the game of hockey for a man that size. Fuhr almost had this covered up, but he let it get away from him. Maybe a little bit of nervousness again. He was a little late on the draw, but Big Kerr, after this centering pass from the corner by Goulet, just tried to jam it topside right there. I think it went off Grant Fuhr's trapper, the goalpost, and into the stands.
10:04 to go in the first period. 50 seconds to go on the power play for the Wales Conference. Kevin Lowe with a check, knocks the puck into the corner. Kevin Lowe blocking it again. Cross ice feed by Prop for Naslin. Howardchuk able to drive it out of the zone. Ruotsalainen goes back for the puck with 30 seconds to go on the power play. Wales Conference in the white jerseys. And carrying the puck is Mark Howe, tied up from behind by Anderson. Now it's Dave Poulin with the puck. Poulin, the captain of the Philadelphia Flyers, drops it off for Brian Propp, his teammate. Propp, back pass to Ruotsalainen, and across to Mark Howe. The deflection goes wide. It's played by Poulin. He's blocked by Kevin Lowe. With 8 seconds to go on the power play, Naslund has the puck. Matt Naslund of the Montreal Canadiens to Mark Howe. Back to Naslund. Naslund walking in, feet to the side of the net for Propp. Knocked aside by Fuhr, it's Naslund with the puck. Teams are back at full strength as Suter returns. Ruotsalainen's wrist shot deflected over the top by Poulin. Just under 9 minutes to go in the first period, there's no score. Mark Messier of the Campbell All-Stars sending it ahead. Now it's Paul Coffey. Coffey of the Edmonton Oilers tries to hit his teammate Glenn Anderson. Anderson recovers. And they regroup in their own zone. 8.5 minutes to go in this first period. There is no score. The puck worked loose by Bossy momentarily. Around it goes, and out of the zone they come. This is Dale Howardchuk of the Winnipeg Jets. Howardchuk makes the move on Langway, and it's steered aside by Goslin. Off his stick, loose in front. Trotche has the puck, leaves it for Langway.
It's an interesting play by Howardchuk as he beat Langway somewhat. And when he shot the puck, he went against the green, Sam. Almost caught Goslin moving in the wrong direction.
Wales Conference All-Stars are offside with 8:12 to go. In the first period, there is no score. We're at the Hartford Civic Center for the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game. Tom Meese, what's going on downstairs?
Well, not downstairs, Sam. Upstairs, one of the spacious super boxes here at the Hartford Civic Center. This has to be the best seat in the house. Not only do you get some fine food, you also get a great view of the action of the All-Star Game on the ice, Sam.
Yeah, but you have to understand, Tom, everywhere is downstairs to us. We're sitting on the roof. 8 minutes to go. In the first period, there's no score. Sent in by Kirk Muller. Stopped side of the net by Grant Fuhr, playing in his fourth All-Star game. Over goes Howardchuk, number 10. Wendell Clark of the Toronto Maple Leafs, the rookie. It's a 2-on-1. Clark goes in and hits the post. The rebound goes wide. Sent wide by Mark Hunter. What a good effort by Wendell Clark.
If you see that wrist shot by Wendell Clark, he is getting a reputation quickly amongst the goaltenders in the National Hockey League about the use of Wendell Clark's wrist shot.
Oh, I just saw a body check by Wendell Clark. The 19-year-old knocked down Brian Trotche. Here's Howe with a shot saved by Fuhr. And suddenly the action picks up a little bit. Puck is cleared out of the zone by Dave Taylor, taken back in by Howe. Howe dropping it off. It's knocked away. Picked up by Ogrodnik, and his pass out is for Neil Broughton. Hooked from behind by Mike Gartner. Penalty upcoming. That shot is stopped by Goslin, and a penalty has been called. Power play coming up for the Campbell All-Stars with 7:05 to go first period. There's no score.
What the...
here's a look at the best scoring chances we've seen so far in the first period. Wendell Clark, look at the flexibility of that hockey stick. When he leans into it, he's farm boy strong. And what a shot off the goalpost. Right there you saw Hunter come in and just get it off the heel of his stick as he was left all alone. Moments after that, Mark Howe had a pretty good chance with a wrist shot himself.
I like that. What do you mean by farm boy strong? Here's a chance in front that comes all the way through.
Wendell Clark lives in the province of Saskatchewan. His family farm there, and he takes all summer trains out there by lifting hay bales, and saw the results of that, that farm boy toughness that he has.
Power play opportunity for the Campbell Conference All-Stars, the Western All-Stars, if you will, as they come in and set up the power play. You got the man in, one man in front. The back pass is to Coffey at the right point. Sends it ahead for Dave Taylor. Taylor's side of the net is knocked away. Still loose behind the net. Taylor going for the puck, trying to beat Robinson on it. Robinson sending it ahead. Kept in by Broughton. The back pass is to Coffey for the shot that deflects wide of the net. Still loose. Broughton picks it up. Ogrodnik is behind the net. Savard is in front. Rather, Taylor is in front. Deflected. Conference All-Stars keeping the puck in. Coffey sending it across to Wilson. Nice feed for Broughton, and he just missed connection with Taylor. Trottier picks up the puck. 50 seconds to go. The penalty to Mike Gardner. Trottier shanked that clearing effort. Here comes Messier in. The backhander knocked away with a blocker by Gosselin. The rebound. Dave hit somebody in the crease. Here's Coffey keeping the puck in. Langway takes it away, looks up ice and lifts it out. Half a minute to go in Gartner's penalty. 5.5 minutes to go first period. There's no score. Wales Conference All-Stars with 5 shots on goal. Campbell with 3. Tanti is stopped by Poulin in center. Poulin, a fine penalty killer. Tough, aggressive player. Signed as a free agent by the Philadelphia Flyers. Here's Croft coming in. Deflects up into the crowd. Poulin, what a story out of Notre Dame. Went and played in Sweden. Then signed with the Philadelphia Flyers as a free agent. There's Brian Propp, who's had an outstanding career. 3 of the last 4 years, a 40-goal scorer.
This time another good save. This time it was on Messier by Gosselin. Again, Gosselin was moving to his left and had to come back to his right side, Sam. You'll see good goal scorers like Mark Messier do that a lot. Look at the balance that Gosselin showed as he was able to recover and make a second save. Not much knocking down of bodies in front of the net, but Mario Gosselin, he's had a history of bad knees, and a lot of people are questioning the fact that how long will he last as a professional goaltender. A lot of people in Quebec hope a long time.
Across the line, Savard has it knocked away by Ramsey. And the teams are back at full strength, and across the line comes Goulet, sending it to the far side. Messier over skates. It's picked up by Lemieux. He shoots, and it's wide. Rebound to the near side. 4:50 to go in the first period. There's no score. Wales Conference All-Stars, the Eastern All-Stars in the white. They're the home team. Michel Goulet has the puck. And now it's Lemieux across the line on the 3-on-2. Tim Kerr shoots, stopped by Fuhr. The rebound stopped by Fuhr on Lemieux. And 2-on-2, they come down. Dennis Savard of the Chicago Blackhawks offside. As he stick-handled at the line, they went across the line offside with 4:33 to go. First period in the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game. There's no score.
Ever since I was 6 years old, I've been faster than anyone.
Why didn't somebody hit him?
I can't catch him.
Oh. I think all hockey players should know how to read and write.
You're tougher than that. You know it, and I know.
I can play the game, and so can you.
Rob Lowe, Cynthia Gibb, Patrick Swayze, Youngblood, rated R. Now playing. Check newspapers for a theater near you.
One of the keys you see with these players in an All-Star game is they don't miss the chances they get. The 3-on-2 created. Lemieux made a nice play over to Kerr. Shot, rebound. Lemieux, he went right for the front of the net. And Grant Furjon held his ground and made the second save as well.
He's had 3 or 4 good saves in this first period. The reaction saves. Grant Fuhr is a good athlete, period. And his athletic ability really helped him play goal. He's in fantastic shape.
Not had a lot of offense here in the first period. Only 7-3 shots on goal.
But some quality shots.
Yes.
Stick up those goaltenders.
Muller comes across the line. Nice feed to Trottier. He's in, and it's knocked away. What a play by Grant Fuhr as he spun around 4 times. Fuhr plays it off the boards to Curry and around the far side. Now back to the near side for Curry. Muller, who's played well in this first period.
working the corner. The puck sent all the way down. Mark Howe is back for it. Mark Howe, who played several years with the Whalers, first in the WHA, then in the NHL before going to the Philadelphia Flyers. Robinson taking it away. And it's sent all the way down. This will be an icing as Kevin Lowe goes back. And did he beat John O'Grodnik to it? No, he didn't. It's taken away by Mike Gardner. Loose puck in front come through the skates of Gardner. Gardner trying to keep it in the zone. Mike Gardner, the Washington Capitals, their high-scoring right wing. Curry able to knock it out of the zone. Gretzky behind the backhand to Anderson. In against Langway. Anderson misses, then recovers. Curry has the puck. Feeds Gretzky. Gretzky to Coffey. It's broken up. Good play coming back by Michel Goulet. Sent across to Curry. In front for Anderson. It's off his skate. Sent across and deflected by Peter Stastny. Kept in by Coffey for a shot off the glove of Goslin. Picked up by Turgeon. Sylvain Turgeon of the Hartford Whalers gets the roar as he comes across with a shot off the stick of Coffey and into the crowd. With 2:51 to go, first period at the Hartford Civic Center. The Wales Conference All-Stars, the Campbell Conference All-Stars, no score.
Give me a light. Bud Light.
If you just ask for a light beer.
Hey, can I have a light? Whoa.
You never know what you'll get.
Give me a light.
Bud Light. So if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste, don't just ask for a light beer.
Give me a light.
Ask them to bring out their best.
Bud Light.
Bud Light. Because everything else is just a light.
Muller makes a great play to get the puck to Trache as both defensemen went to Muller. And look at Grandpuir drag his left leg across as Trache comes into him. And he is stretched out about as far as he can and reaches back and pulls the puck right off the stick of Brian Trache. Trache cannot believe it. Good stop by Grandpuir. Interesting to see both defensemen go over to Muller. And Muller made a great play to just to pop the puck to the open man, which is Trache. Ristolainen and Ramsey. Mike Ramsey of the Buffalo Sabres, number 6, has the puck. Ramsey, right on the U.S. Olympic team in 1980. Nice pass to Mats Naslund. The back pass comes to Poulin. And it's taken back by Dale Howardchuk. Howardchuk to Paul Coffey with 2:25 to go in the first period. No score. Goslin sends the puck around. The open man on the near side is Brian Propp. Sends out Poulin. And across the rail, Ruotsalainen. Nice cut to the inside. Ruotsalainen comes in. The backhander is blocked in front.
That's what he likes to do, doesn't he? Just skate to the wide open ice.
Across the line comes John O'Grodnik. Excuse me, that's Wendell Clark, number 15. Back come the Wales Conference All-Stars. Ruotsalainen with a drop again. Mats Naslund comes in behind the net, trying to get it out in front. Naslund recovers on the near boards. Kept in by Mark Howe. Howe still has the puck, looking for some room. Walks down the slot, drops it off. The shot goes wide. Deflected wide by Fuhr. And picked up by Howardchuk behind the net. With a minute 35 to go in the first period.
And the action has slowed down a little bit now.
Interesting to see Goulet and Lemieux on the same line, both French Canadians. They could speak in their native French language. Help them on the ice, a little communication.
Mickey can speak to them too, right, man?
Once in a while.
Here comes Lemieux across the line, trying to feed in front for Goulet. Howe stops the puck. Backhands it ahead. Goulet, trying to get a shot off, is tied up, wrapped up by Gary Suter.
Suter's doing a lot of holding down there.
And out come the Campbell Conference All-Stars. Dave Taylor across the line. Taylor with a drop pass. Shot by Suter is stopped by Goslin. Out of the zone it comes with 1 minute to go in the first period. No score in this 38th National Hockey League All-Star game. Intercept by Robinson. Across the line, Lemieux. Drop to Robinson. That shot deflected, blocked by Suter. And Gary Suter has the puck. Gary Suter, the rookie from the Calgary Flames.
Sam, the defensemen are joining the play quite a bit. That last play, Robinson was up. Coffey's joined the play. Bork has joined the play. I like this. It's a little offensive display here. This guy's getting the chance to move ahead and get involved.
Half a minute to go, and here comes Dennis Savard against Bork. Bork takes the puck away. Good play by the all-star Ray Bork. Four times in his six seasons, Ray Bork has been a first-team National Hockey League all-star at the end of the season. 21 seconds to go, first period. There's no score. Expected, not too much physical play, very little, maybe one or two hits, a little, couple of grabs and one tripping in there. Gary Suter got called for a hold. There was one trip,
And each team had a power play opportunity. A couple of good offensive moves, I thought.
I think a lot of tentative play on both parts, Sam. Not many shots on goal. John pointed out some good ones, though. I think we'll see it open up a lot more later in that period, John. You notice the defense starting getting in the offense as well.
I also thought that both goaltenders played very well. Goslin, your good reaction saves good goaltending, and I like that. I don't get enough credit.
You're watching the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game on ESPN. End of one. There is no score. We'll be back in just a moment.
One teams in the National Hockey League. The University of Connecticut Health Center welcomed the NHL All-Stars for the UConn Children's Cancer Ward, which is the team charity of the Hartford Whalers. Over the last 4 years, the Whalers have donated over $400,000 to the Children's Cancer Fund, and yesterday another $100,000 was presented by the NHL from proceeds of last night's All-Star dinner. It was also a time for awards. Edmonton's All-Star defenseman Paul Coffey was given the Procter & Gamble Cup as the league's top vote getter.
Thank you. First of all, I'd like to thank the fans around the league. It's a great honor for me to receive the votes that I did receive. I also think that this type of system is going to benefit the league because it is creating a lot of interest around the league for the fans. And last but not least, I'd like to thank my mother for stuffing the ballot box 100,000 times.
Only 25, yet six times an NHL All-Star, Boston's Ray Bourque received the Chrysler Dodge Cup. And surprisingly, both conferences' top vote-getters were defensemen.
First of all, I'd like to thank all you fans that did vote for me. It's a great honor knowing that people around the league appreciate your play. And I was very surprised by being in the lead in the vote-getter. And I'd also like to thank Chrysler Dodge for the beautiful trophy. And I do hope you enjoy the game tomorrow night. Thank you.
But battles on the ice paled by comparison to the battles being waged by the youngsters in the Children's Cancer Ward. The NHL All-Stars were there to share some personal time and perhaps lift some spirits. It turned out those kids did as much giving as receiving.
I'll tell you, they're an inspiration to us. You know, the battle that they're going through certainly makes the battles that we have on the ice pale in comparison. You know, they're all wearing the jerseys and they've got a smile on their faces, and I tell you, they're lifting up our spirits.
More than a hockey team is not merely a catchy phrase. It is a commitment from the Hartford Whalers to give back to the community. And that's what they and the NHL All-Stars did yesterday. Not just in monetary terms, now over $500,000, but also in terms of time. Time given, time spent, and a time to be treasured. Last night, the ice was cubed and the glasses chilled as over 1,500 jammed into the Civic Center to raise additional money for the Children's Cancer Fund. The event, like the game itself, long since sold out. And the dinner featured two since-retired NHL All-Stars as honorary captains, Gordie Howe and Phil Esposito. And, of course, the current All-Stars were on hand, too, along with NHL general managers and coaches league-wide. It was also a time to remember, as the fans across North America did, by voting the late Pelle Lindbergh an NHL All-Star jersey, which he would have worn tonight.
I just wanted to say thank you, everybody, on behalf of Pelle, me, and the Lindbergh family. Thank you.
There were also two Lester Patrick trophies awarded for outstanding lifetime hockey service. One to John McGinnis of Michigan Tech, as his wife accepted. The other to Jack Riley at point. And the entertainment of the evening provided by some of Hollywood's biggest names.
Hello, gardening friends. I'm John Dromgoole, and I'd like to...
All hockey fans, even those who never saw
him play. He is Mr. Hockey, number 9, Gordie Howe. He is simply regarded as hockey's greatest player ever. He simply is hockey's greatest scorer. With over 800 goals and over 1,800 points, this former member of the production line in Detroit was smooth and quick, but also rough and tough.
People knew what kind of a force he was on the ice and how nasty he could be. And nobody wanted to test him. I remember one occasion when Bobby Miller ran into one of his sons, I think it was Marty Howe, and the next thing you know, we were scraping Bobby Miller off the ice with about a 10-stitch cut over his eye, and Gordie was heading back to the bench, so I certainly gave him a lot of room.
It was an awesome feeling to play against Gordie Howe. It was one of the few times I've been at a hockey game. Actually, I was coming out of knee surgery, and we were playing a game. He was playing for the Hartford Whalers, and he scored a goal on me that game, and I think that's the only time in my whole career that I never felt bad when somebody had scored a goal. I was able to say, hey, listen, Gordie Howe scored on me. He was a great player.
Howe
Howe's durability, Mark, may never be touched. 26 years in hockey with three teams and two leagues. His number retired in Detroit and Hartford. Strength, grace, intelligence, all spell out Mr. Hockey, Gordie Howe, the honorary captain this year of the Clarence Campbell Conference in the All-Star Game.
And hello again, everyone. I'm Tom Meese with Mr. Hockey number 9, Gordie Howe. Gordie, the ovation you received when you took the ice tonight, introduced as the honorary captain of the Wales Conference, you're telling me you never get used to that kind of adulation from the crowd.
No, I never will anyway. And it, I felt perfectly healthy until I got out here. And then when that happened, I'm nervous over again. And it's, but I think it, I was a little concerned. You know, sometimes when you get my age in particular and then excitement and you feel awkward, especially the way the kids out there are skating tonight. And then, but I would say what we're really representing and what you've seen in a lot of All-Star games and other sports is the present is there because that's the game. And then Phil and I represented the past. He was much older than I am, so so we represent the past. And then we brought the young guy out to represent the future, which is a boost to all kids. Anybody can make it as long as they fall in love with the game, willing to work at it.
Gordie, of course, your long career is history, 26 years. You played in an All-Star game at age 51. When you see a rookie like Wendell Clark getting his first taste, what goes through your mind?
Well, probably he's no different than any other kid when born up with the expectations of playing in a league. And then when you have some success, which he's had in Toronto, then you feel that maybe this might be a year or maybe I might be a future All-Star. And he's getting his shot, and he's the only one probably overexcited. He's throwing the body around a little bit. And that's the way the game, I know Mark come off after he hit him. He said, it's kind of surprised. He laughed, and he said, the kid is trying. Yeah. So that's, you got to pay more tribute. And he's a great hockey player, and he has so many potentials going for him. I saw him in Toronto a couple of games, and was absolutely perfect moves, and he had come up with goals. And naturally, when he's out there, same as Sylvain Turgeon had talked to him, he says, I'm a little nervous. What do I do? And I said, well, get a lot nervous. That's the way we all started. So he said, well, I have dreams of driving the car home. So they're all dreaming.
Gordie, as always, thanks for being with us, and good luck in the future.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
Number 9, Mr. Hockey, Gordie Howe, our guest between the first and second period of the 38th NHL All-Star Game. I'll be back with NHL President John Ziegler in a moment. And John, the All-Star Game, always a case for celebration in the National Hockey League, and especially here in Hartford this year.
Well, it's been great. The Hartford fans have been outstanding. The Hartford people have been great. And watching Gordie Howe and Phil Esposito come on the ice gave me a great thrill. I was just thinking, next to Gordie and his family, I bet you I've seen more standing ovations for Gordie Howe than any other hockey fan.
And going you never get tired defense. Of it, do you?
No, I got the same thrill as I did the first time I saw him.
I want to ask you something about hockey this year in the NHL. Franchises that were said to be in trouble last year, for example, Hartford, for example, Pittsburgh. These franchises have turned around now, and they could legitimately be called healthy franchises.
Well, Hartford's always been a healthy franchise. The fans have been disappointed because their team hasn't made the playoffs, but their management and their ownership have been as solid as any team in the league. Their performance, of course, is certainly heartening to everybody in hockey. They've done it from the ground up, and everybody should be proud of that. We've seen Pittsburgh come on. New Jersey is struggling, but they've got great work ethic out there. And if there's really true parity, we're coming as close to it as I think you can get. I don't think you'll ever really have it even.
John, while I have you here, one serious question I'd like to get a quick answer. The Board of Governors has met during this All-Star break. The Players Association has met. One gets the feeling that the negotiations on a new contract with the players are going to be tough this year. How do you think it's going to come out?
Well, they're going to be tough, and probably the toughest we've had. But both owners and players, as indicated this morning when we met with the players, have dedicated themselves once again to solving problems at the bargaining table, not using it as a place of confrontation. And I think owners and players in this league can be proud of the fact that that's why we haven't had strikes and we've been able to come with agreement.
Let's hope that strike is one word we never hear in the National Hockey League. Thank you very much, NHL President John Ziegler. We'll be back with the second period of play live from Hartford, the NHL All-Star Game, 38th edition, right here on ESPN in just a moment.
I'm Jim Kelly, John Davidson, ex-goaltending great of the New York Rangers alongside. Speaking of goaltending, zip to zip, are you surprised?
I am somewhat because they had some real good scoring opportunities out there. There wasn't many, but they were good ones, and the goaltenders were really good. I thought both played very well, Goslin and Fuhr, and they both have similar styles in that they are acrobatic, and we saw some acrobatic saves.
All right, let's go to one of the replays right now and take a look at one of the great acrobatic saves by Mario Gosselin.
Well, first of all, Gretzky has 104 assists, and there you see why. It's a great pass to Anderson, and Glenn Anderson plays the game in full speed, and Gosselin had to be quick to get across. We'd mentioned during the first period that Gosselin has a history of bad knees, you can see why he has bad knees. He's up and down, he's flying all over the place, and he plays basically with reckless abandon, and he was good in that first period.
Well, when our cameras took you inside the locker room, you saw the brace that Mario Gosselin wears. What's it like for a goaltender to be playing with braces
actually,
on?
Actually, Grant Fuhr wears a brace on his shoulder because he's afraid of getting his shoulder popped out of place. He's had problems with it, and what he can't do is lift that one shoulder up over 90 degrees, so the brace keeps it in place. There you saw Grant Fuhr's style. He loves to play back and forth across the goal crease, and he's so athletically strong. What they do with the Edmonton Oilers is monitor his weight, and whenever he's under 185 pounds, they seem to say he plays really well. He's weighing at 182 right now. If he gets up over top of 185, they watch him again and tell him no more meatballs and the spaghetti.
There's the beef, right?
Right.
You talk about the acrobatic goaltending of Pittsburgh's Mario Gosselin, but what about the play right here of Grant Fuhr?
Well, Grant Fuhr, again, we look at the flexibility of Grant Fuhr, how he likes to move across, and what he has an ability of doing is being on one goal post and getting himself way out in front of the goal crease quickly. His quickness is incredible. And the way the Edmonton Oilers play sometime in their own zone, he's used to making saves like we just saw.
Well, it was almost a goal. The one hit the post. Let's take a look down here.
Wendell Clark, we talked about his strength. See Hunter here, number 20. He's going to follow up the play, and he'll never get a better chance than this and panic somewhat. Rod Langway late getting to the play, but Gosselin was way out, played the angle very well. The Wendell Clark wrist shot, boy, is he strong, and a lot of goaltenders are talking about him all over the league. He likes to use the wrist shot, and there he saw a little bad luck, he hit the goalpost.
All right, get back upstairs, get ready for the second period of play. John Davidson, right. And he'll be back in our next intermission. It's nothing-nothing. Campbell Conference going up against the Wales Conference, and it's the 38th All-Star Game here on ESPN. Sam Rosen, Mickey Redmond, John Davidson, Jim Kelly, and Tom Meese. Second period action coming up.
You're watching the best in the National Hockey League in action in Hartford in the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game. It's being brought to you by the full line of 1986 Volkswagen. By the U.S. Navy. Navy, it's not just a job, it's an adventure. And by Bud Light, the light beer with a first name and taste. Everything else is just a light.
We are just about set to start the second period here at the Hartford Civic Center. There is no score, as you saw in the highlights. There were several good scoring chances in that first period. You know, Mick, a lot of people talk about a format change in the All-Star game, but I don't know. What do you think? Could they really adapt a format change that might bring more interest or more excitement to the game? I think right now it's basically a showcase, and perhaps the fans understand that, right? There really hasn't been tremendous tradition built up between Wales Conference and Campbell Conference. I don't think too many fans understand which is which. A lot has to do with the fact that teams have moved around and there have been switching of teams from different divisions.
I don't think they really would like to get any more activity into the All-Star game, more than it being a showcase, really, Sam. I feel that's the way it should be. Some of the greatest players in the game. You talk about other guys. The fans, I think, did a pretty good job this year. There's obviously people that could be here and should be here from other teams, but everybody can't, and that's been going on for years, even when the writers were picking the players and coaches were filling in after that. But I think the fans basically did a pretty good job of picking the top players around the league, and they've always had the representation from at least one club in the All-Star game. But I don't think they want it to be an intense situation. It's a couple of days, it's a break in the middle of the season for the players to relax, have a little bit of fun, and showcase their great talents.
How do you like that view from the Midgey Camp? We're in the goal, looking out from behind Mario Gosselin. Underway, the Wales Conference All-Stars in the white, and the Campbell Conference All-Stars in the orange. Second period underway, Doug Wilson of the Chicago Blackhawks with the puck. Dwayne Gretzky, stopped by Langway, holds him a little bit. Curry fires rink wide to Glenn Anderson, comes in with room on a two-on-one. He fakes, he tried to get it through to Gretzky, was blocked, and covered up. Good play, sliding across by Ray Bourque, the outstanding defenseman of the Boston Bruins.
Well, all a fella can do on a two-on-one is stay in the middle, basically. Let the goaltender handle the shooter. And Bourque just sort of flopped his body down, forced Anderson off to the corner at a bad angle, and he didn't have anything to do with it. There you see Gretzky on the left side of your screen, who went for the corner of the net, but Glenn Anderson not able to get the shot or pass through to him. Raymond Bourque, just a tremendous defenseman, offense, defense. There's another shot in that midget cam. We'll get more of those as the night goes. They should be interesting. You get some guys coming off the wing, cutting in the shots, the goaltender moving out.
Round it goes to Michel Goulet of the Quebec Nordiques.
second in the National Hockey League in power play goals this season with 25. Doug Wilson keeps it in, gets it ahead to Gretzky. Gretzky centers for Curry. Curry to Anderson. You know, it almost seems that some of the players are looking to make the pretty pass, as you said, to try and impress the other people with that fine pinpoint passing.
Time goes on, I think you'll see less and less of that. They can make great plays, there's no question about it. They try to get too pretty, and they don't develop.
Here comes Gretzky with Curry following. Drops to Curry, who knocks it down. It's deflected. That shot wide by Coffey. Coffey goes back to retrieve it. Checked by Tim Kerr. Coffey keeps it in, sends it side of the net, and Langway almost knocked it in and then knocked it out. Here comes Lemieux. Back is Coffey. Lemieux comes in with a shot. Stop is made by Fuhr. The rebound is stopped again by Fuhr. The goaltender is dominating here. That puck comes across the blue line. They're offside. John, how about that?
They talked about Grant Fuhr and that athletic ability. He kept his eye on the puck, reached up and batted it out.
18:37 to go. Second period in the 38th All-Star Game. There's no score. Robinson picked up by Gretzky. Nice feed to Curry. He shoots. Saved by Gosselin. Sent around by Markow, but stopped by Ramage. Wristed toward the net. It's blocked by Robinson. Anderson shoots, and it's blocked in front. Gretzky feed for Kevin Lowe. He shoots. Oh. Glove save by Gosselin. Kevin Lowe, who has not scored a goal this season, almost bought one in the All-Star game. 14 minutes to go, second period. There's no score.
Set your court.
Well, the Campbells get a very good scoring opportunity set up by Wayne Gretzky with a little flip pass into the slot area to Kevin Lowe, and look what happens after Lowe gets it on his stick.
Up top, Mario Gosselin, who had two shutouts the first two games he ever played professionally. He's got one going here. Look at the save. He waits for Lowe to shoot it. Lowe has to go high because the stick was coming out from the defenseman. May even have deflected a little bit, and Gosselin was right on top of it.
Goaltender shining tonight, Mario Gosselin for the Wales Conference. Grant Fuhr for the Campbell Conference. No score. As Brian Trottier sends the puck around, it's almost time for the starting goaltenders to leave. They'll be leaving in a little over 3 minutes.
I was going to say, with all due respect to John and the goaltender, Sam, I think it's time we got some scoring in the game.
Now, when those goaltenders leave, the nets won't be empty. The backups will take over. Andy Moog and Bob Froese. Corner. The puck is kept in by Trottier as he battles along the boards, but it's finally worked out by Wendell Clark, number 15. Wendell Clark of the Toronto Maple Leafs with a shot that deflects up into the crowd, stopping play with 13:08 to go.
Sam, I believe it was Mark Howe with a great pass right up the ice to Kirk Muller, and then Kevin Lowe did his best to get back to Muller and then try and break up the play somewhat. Muller's in on top of the goaltender. He's all alone. And watch quickly from behind. There's Kevin Lowe harassing him somewhat, and that made him lose his balance. You saw how far the goaltender, Grant Fuhr, was out above that goal crease as he was playing the breakaway. And again, you see the athletic ability of Grant Fuhr as Muller took him right out of the play.
I think there could have been a penalty very easily called on the play as Muller was in one-on-one with Fuhr.
I'd love to have seen a penalty shot.
Out come the Wales Conference All-Star Stastny pass. It's Turgeon. Turgeon is tied up from behind. Bump by Turgeon to get the puck back. Turgeon trying to work his way in front. It's loose and shot wide by Mike Gartner. Bork, rather Coffey, has the puck. There's the zone off the stick of Panty. Now it's Peter Stastny across the line. Checked by Wilson. Shot by Turgeon is a save. And the rebound knocked over the top as Gartner was knocked down in front. And Grant Fuhr was stuffed in the net.
Oh, we get a little bit of action now offensively. Sylvain Turgeon, the favorite here at the Civic Center in Hartford, taking the place of Ron Francis, the injured Ron Francis, gets a couple of scoring chances. That's the first one right there, and boy, Fuhr is as sharp as I've seen him in a while, John.
He's in real good shape again. I'd mentioned that before. They monitor Grant Fuhr's weight, and he's in the best shape of his career. He's coming back from a couple of injuries earlier on this season. Look at Mike Gartner follow up the play and try and bunt the puck into the open side, and Coffey took care of Gartner. But that line looked like they were going pretty good, or at least Gartner and Turgeon playing well together.
Turgeon had another chance there in front of the net. He sort of mishandled the puck a little bit. Glenn Sather with Alan Thick, who was hosting the shootout here after the first period.
Alan Thick, the assistant coach tonight. Jack Riley is also on the bench. Jack Riley, who is
received one of the awards last night at the banquet.
Glenn Taylor liked to get a win. He's lost his only two appearances as the head coach in the All-Star contest.
Robinson sending the puck down, and this will be an icing call with 12:19 to go. Second period, 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game at the Hartford Civic Center. There's no score.
A Bud Light.
If you just ask for a light beer, you never know what you'll get.
Case of light? No, Bud Light.
So if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste, don't just ask for a light beer.
Give me light.
Ask them to bring out their best.
A Bud Light.
Bud Light. Because everything else,
thanks,
is just a light.
How do you like that look, John? That's the goaltender's view. There you see how he plays his angles. That's the camera sitting right on top of the goal net. It's called a midgy cam. There it is. It's able to move the remote control sideways, up and down. It's quite an addition.
Of course, everybody expects that thing is going to get dinged by somebody shooting the puck, and then we'll find out what happens.
I figure Gosselin would turn it around and pose a little bit.
Mickey Redmond would hit it. That's where he shot the puck all the time.
Tanti comes in with a drive. He scores! Tony Tanti of the Vancouver Canucks breaks the shutout with 12:04 to go in the second period. The first goal of the game is scored by the outstanding goal scorer of the Vancouver Canucks, Tony Tanti.
Mario Gosselin can't believe that he didn't stop this shot. I think the puck may have just slowed down somewhat. He overplayed it.
It's like he surprised him, John, a little bit, didn't he?
Right.
He shot from way out.
Well, he used the screens a little bit. And you see him just shoot it inside the goalpost. Gosselin was well out, but he got a piece of it.
Looked like he may have been a little bit too far to the goalpost, the short side. And Tanti, who can shoot the puck and is a natural goal scorer, look at Gosselin, can't seem to reach any further.
When he reached that far, the front end of his blade lifted up off the ice and the puck went underneath. I think he just overplayed it a little bit, Mickey.
Campbell All-Stars lead it 1-0. Tony Tanti. Now Goulet shoots and a save by Pure. Loose in front, Pure covers up. The big Tim Kerr right there. 11:48 to go in the second period. The action picking up a little bit. Tom Meese, what's going on in the stands?
All right, Sam, I'm in the upper deck. The Flames may no longer be in Atlanta, but their Atlanta Flames fans are here. The Flames in Calgary. What are you guys from Atlanta doing here watching the All-Star game in Hartford?
Well, Tom, we're just sort of spending our season ticket money up here.
Are there no games in Atlanta?
No, but there are games all over north in Canada, so we come up and enjoy them.
Is hockey ever going to come back to the South?
We hope, but it depends.
All right, the Atlanta Flames Fan Club is here in strength in Hartford. Sam?
Well, they've got some great fans down in Atlanta. Poulin has the puck for the Whales. Got for centers, and the shot went over the top by Prop. This is Naslund with the puck. Naslund with a back pass. Robinson with a wrist shot deflected wide. Poulin picks up the puck. Poulin centers, knocked away by Ogrodnik. Out come the Campbell All-Stars, who lead 1-0 on the goal by Tony Tanti at 7:56, unassisted. Gosselin sending the puck around and stopped by Prop. Ryan Prop goes across to Matt Naslund, the leading scorer of the Montreal Canadiens. Naslund is tied up. Puck kept in. Shot ahead. Prop didn't get much wood on that. Rob Ramage has the puck, and around it goes to Dave Taylor of the LA Kings. Taylor gets the pass back from Broughton, puts it in front. Bork is there to intercept. Broughton trying to tee one up, and it's knocked away. Ogrodnik finds it. Back to Ramage for the drive. Deflected and stopped in front by Gosselin. Naslund comes out. That's Naslund, who scored over 40 goals last season and will repeat that this season. He's having another great year. Puck sent back into the Wales zone, and Bork sends it across to Rod Langway, the two-time Norris Trophy winner, and is the best defenseman in the National Hockey League, 1983-84. Bork. Muller with a back pass to Langway, the captain of the Washington Capitals. Trying to clear the zone, it's taken back by Curry. Here comes Gretzky. Gretzky controls the puck. Gretzky with a nice pass between the legs of Trotche. That shot is knocked away by Gosselin. Back behind the net, they battle. Ray Bork knocked away from him. Gretzky has the puck. Centers for Anderson. It was knocked away, and Ray Bork has it. Out come the Wales Conference All-Stars. Kirk Muller, second player drafted last year in 1984, I should say. Brian Trotche has it. Tied up by Kevin Lowe. Curry is looking. It's kicked free to Bossy. Bossy with Muller hanging in the slot. Bossy tied up by Lee Fogelin of the Edmonton Oilers. Edmonton Oilers have 9 players playing in the All-Star game. Shot by Ruotsalainen and deflects into the corner. And Jari Kurri picks it up. Philadelphia Flyers have five players in the All-Star game. And, of course, those two teams met in the Stanley Cup Finals last year. Feed for Anderson is stopped once again by Gosselin. Beautiful save by Mario Gosselin. Gretzky's pass deflected. Out comes Bossy. Doug Wilson is back to meet him. Bossy across the line. Bossy shoots, saved by Pure. Puck picked up by Paul Coffey. A three-man rush down the ice. A nice feed for Wendell Clark, but it's broken up by Ruotsalainen. Gartner gets the puck to Peter Stasny. Three-man rush across the line. Gartner fell down, and the puck went flying into the corner. Gartner gets another try. He fans. Gartner shoots a save by Fjord. 8:57 to go. Second period. Grant Fjord won't let them score. Good goaltending at both ends we've seen so far in the first half of the game. Kevin Lowe joins the play, not an offensive defenseman. He sets up Anderson. Now look how quickly Gosselin gets across. Anderson couldn't quite get it up top. Anderson has so much speed, sometimes he goes by that net too quickly. Mike Gartner had a little bit of trouble handling the puck. He's fanned a little bit right in front. Everybody watching, including Grant Fuhr. He always seems to find it. Grant Fuhr, his average this year is 4.63, which is high. But you can see how good he is. Now he's healthy, he's back into shape again, and he's played well. We've had goaltending changes. Bob Froese going in. Bob Froese from the Philadelphia Flyers, and Andy Moog. Grant Fuhr's backup. Andy Moog has had a better year than Grant Fuhr. Fuhr was injured much of the first part of the season. Andy Moog came in, played very well on the road for them. You'll see, Sam, Bob Froese is a stand-up, very technically sound goaltender. Andy Moog is built on quickness and controlling rebounds. Even there, when he's knocking the puck down, he's putting them into the corner. He's handling them well. He's very, very, very quick.
Now, you see Edmonton a lot, John. Do the Oilers play any differently in front of Moog and Fuhr?
No, I don't think so. They play a quick transitional game. If they're not sharp mentally, their goaltenders are going to get a lot of work.
Mario Gosselin played a real fine game as he stopped 12 of 13 shots in 31 minutes of action.
John, of course, the regular rule in the season here, no warm-ups allowed. They allow them here in the All-Star game for obvious reasons, that not the pressure on, but what difference does that make to a goaltender? It's got to make a lot of difference when he hasn't got a chance to warm up in a game condition.
Well, I think it makes a lot of difference, and you're looking at a person that may be driving a new car before this game's over. He was sensational. He really was.
He certainly got to be number one in the first period and a half of this hockey game.
To be thinking MVP unless somebody busts loose and scores a lot of goals. 1-0 the score. Campbell Conference All-Stars with the puck in the lead. Dale Hawerchuk comes in on a 2-on-1 and shoots wide. Michel Goulet of the Nordiques speeds Tim Kerr across the line on the three-man rush. They come. Kerr cross ice feed is blocked. It's picked up by Ruotsalainen and his shot is blocked. And back they go the other way. Across the line comes Hawerchuk. Picked up by Ramsey. His pass is deflected. Loose side of the net. And it's covered up, by Bob Froese with 8:29 to go in the second period in the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game. Campbell Conference leading 1-0. Tom Davidson, Jim Kelly, and Tom Mees. As you look from the midget cam that is sitting on the top of the net, right behind Bob Froese. 8:29 to go in the second period of the All-Star game, and we certainly hope you're enjoying it. Sylvain Turgeon of the Hartford Whalers breaks down. Right wing feed for Gartner. Takes it off the board. His pass was blocked. And the Campbell All-Stars clear it out. Murray Robinson. Now it's Gartner coming across the line to Turgeon. Turgeon's shot is blocked. His puck knocked in front. Peter Stastny got tripped up. And the puck taken back by Mark Hunter of the St. Louis Blues. Hunter. Right wing feed for Wendell Clark on the off wing. He tried to center, and Froese stops the puck side of the net with 7:57 to go. Wendell Clark, pretty tough customer. First player picked in the 1985 draft by the Toronto Maple Leafs, and a good pick.
Well, Wendell's had a little bit of problem with injury this year, but he's played very, very well for Toronto. Game in and game out, and as John pointed out, he has got a wrist shot par excellence.
He can play both defense and left wing, too. When he played junior hockey in Saskatoon, he was more of a defenseman than he was left winger, but the Leafs needed power up front. They needed some scoring up front, especially on their left side. And Wendell Clark stepped right in.
He looks like a natural left winger. He did play defensive junior at 253 penalty minutes last year.
You know what he does is he plays as well on the road as he does at home, and that's a good thing to see in a young hockey player.
Tony Tanti, the goal scorer in the game, lifting it up out of the zone, knocked down by Langway, and the feed to Matt Naslund.
Haslin, nice pass, gets it back for Propp and shoots, stopped off the chest of Moog. Oh, someone was pulled down. Propp was pulled down in front, and nothing was called, and the fans react to that. Tony Tanti has the puck knocked away. Comes to Kevin Lowe, fine defenseman of the Edmonton Oilers. Kevin Lowe to Lee Fogelman. They are teamed on defense for the Oilers. Tony Tanti, who started his career with the Chicago Blackhawks, was traded to Vancouver and really blossomed into a fine goal scorer for the Vancouver Canucks. 2 seasons back, he scored 45. This year, he has 31.
He played for 4 teams in 1 year. Again, we look at Bob Prohl's. He was originally drafted by the St. Louis Blues. Out of junior, when he played junior Niagara Falls. Here we can listen to Mike Keenan on the bench.
He was saying that he's just going to play all his players, enjoy the game, yet he knew what the other team's lines were going to be. I asked him if he had tapes from this morning's practice that he could review them all afternoon to set up his pregame scouting. He is a competitor.
Remember this morning, John, we were talking to him, and all 40 players were out on the ice together. They had a bit of a showdown contest here in front of 5,000 or 6,000 people. Keenan came in. He said, well, I'm just going to play all my guys, 4 lines, and let them all go, at least for the start.
At least for the
turned
start.
Around before the game, and I said to him, I don't really have the Campbell lineup. He said, oh, that's too bad. He said, you want him?
Oh, boy.
He's not into the game.
He has the ability to push his players to the limit and get everything out of them. He's very, very well-schooled. He runs a good tight ship in Philadelphia.
Offside is called on the play. 6:44 to go, second period of the 38th. National Hockey League All-Star Game, Campbell Conference leading 1-0.
Presenting the Volkswagen GTI. Car and Driver calls it one of the 10 best cars of 1986.
What you say?
Celebrate. Buy a new GTI by February 28th, and Volkswagen will give you back up to a full year's interest. Get the deal of the year on one of Car and Driver's 10 best cars of 1986.
What you say?
Immediately following the National Hockey League All-Star Game, it's college basketball at its best. Number 1, North Carolina takes on number 2, Georgia Tech. What a matchup. A tape delay broadcast right here on ESPN immediately following tonight's All-Star Game. Off the line, Kirk Muller.
Muller's played very well for the Wales Conference All-Stars.
Just a youngster, second player drafted right behind Mario Lemieux. That feed comes across. John O'Grodnik with a back pass. Wilson just kept it in the zone. I thought it came across the blue line. They said it's still okay. Wilson keeps it in again and shoots. Deflected wide. That rebound goes wide by O'Grodnik, and Muller has the puck.
Muller played on the line with Lemieux last year in Calgary in the All-Star Game, and you all know that Lemieux won the most valuable player. Muller had a lot to do with that. They really clicked well, and they're clicking well here in this particular game.
It's Tim Kerr taking the puck across, dropping it for Lemieux. Lemieux looking around. He's checked and lost the puck to Yari Curry. Curry tries to lead Gretzky. Gretzky takes it off the boards, drops a beautiful pass to Anderson. His shot is blocked. The rebound is stopped by Moog. Excuse me, by Froese. Sent ahead. Glenn Anderson hits the back of the net. It's taken away by Muller to Lemieux. Lemieux with a nice feed for Goulet. Goulet drops it to Bossy. Cuts inside. Bossy trying to tee up a shot. Feeds Lemieux. Lemieux back to Bossy. Tied up by Curry. Kept in by Bork. His shot. Six save made by Moog.
Sam, whenever Bossy gets the puck, he gets it on his forehand. He'll position his body so he can release the puck, whether it be a pass or a shot all the time. When you watch him here, just watch how he positions his body.
Puck deflected by Froese. Bossy comes down with Goulet. Goulet and Ramage are tied up. Over comes Bossy to help out. Looks around. The back pass for Trache is broken up. Out come the Campbell Conference All-Stars. Wayne Gretzky carrying. Langway knocks it away. Bork up the boards but gave it away. Gary Suter coming down from the point is hit by Langway. And out come the Wales Conference All-Stars. Bossy takes the puck across. Trache heads for the net. The feed is deflected just wide. And how many times have they done that for the New York Islanders? That same play, Bossy and Trache, who have clicked for so many years. Mark Hunter of the St. Louis Blues with a back pass. 4:25 to go, second period. 1-0, the Campbell Conference All-Stars. The Western All-Stars leading the East. 1-0. Ruotsalainen has the puck. Rayo Ruotsalainen from Finland. The Frenchman of the New York Rangers. Look at him skate. Drops it off for Gartner. His drive deflected off low. Ruotsalainen is stopped by Moog. Turgeon battling with Fogelin, knocked ahead to Turgeon. Turgeon controls. And then it's worked out of the zone by Dale Hawerchuk. Good play by Hawerchuk. Hunter comes across, but offside on the play was Wendell Clark. We want to take a look back at a special moment in NHL All-Star history right now. The great Wayne Gretzky seems to always be putting a new record into the NHL books. That's how it was in the 1983 All-Star game at the Nassau Coliseum, when the great one became the first player in history to score four goals in an All-Star game. Gretzky led a six-goal third-period explosion by the Campbell Conference as they defeated the Wales Conference 9-3. Wayne Gretzky, MVP of the 1983 NHL All-Star game. The face-off. The Wales Conference All-Stars break in. Peter Stastny trying to center. Does. It's blocked in front by Kevin Lowe. Picked up by Dennis Savard. Sending it out. Across the line comes Messier. Messier for Tanti. Just missed. Just went wide. Good shot by Tanti. Robinson sending it up the boards. Kept in by Tanti. Larry Robinson has it again. 13-year veteran Larry Robinson. Two-time Norris Trophy winner as the top defenseman in the National Hockey League. Puck bounces into the Campbell zone. Turgeon overskated. Peter Stastny has the puck. Back for Turgeon. Good save by Andy Moog, who holds it with 3:09 to go in the second period. Campbell Conference All-Stars leading 1-0. Right now, let's find out what Tom Meese is doing.
The man who really brought the Canadians and the Americans closer together several years ago in the midst of tragic circumstances in Iran, former Canadian ambassador to the U.S., Ken Taylor. Ken, how much hockey do you get to see?
We see a lot. We see the Oilers each time they come. Yeah. And but this is a wonderful game. You can pull for both teams.
You're now with Nabisco Brands, I understand.
That's right, in New York. So we have, of course, see a lot of Bobby Orr, who is also associated with the company.
Hockey brings our two countries closer together, and you certainly did too. Let's go back to Sam Rose.
Thank you, Tom. With 3 minutes to go in the second period, shots are 18-15 for the Wales Conference All-Stars. We get 18-16 now on that shot by Doug Wilson. Matt Snazlin sending out Dave Poulin. Poulin trying to cut inside, has it knocked away. Picked up by Naslin. Naslin centers, comes all the way through. Prop goes over to play it. In the corner, Naslin. Naslin to Poulin. He's checked by Doug Wilson. Wilson just holding Poulin against the boards. Still a loose puck. Poulin digging. Naslin comes over to help out and poke it free. Prop trying to find it for a shot, and out come the Campbell All-Stars. Paul Coffey. Coffey comes across the line and poke checked away. Puck taken back by Dave Poulin. On the boards for Naslin off his skate. And now it's Langway for Naslin. Naslin looks around, drops it back for Bork. Nice move down the slot. Saved by Moog. The rebound score!
Raymond Bork really made this play happen as he went to that offensive position, broke in from the point. Nice setup by Mats Naslin. And here comes Bork. He splits the two forwards down inside. His shot was stopped by Andy Moog, but he couldn't control the rebound, John, and no chance to stop Brian Propp, who's on the goal set.
Well, you know what happens? Everybody was aware that Bork is coming in. They all watch here. There's Paul Coffey. He doesn't know if he wants to stop the shot or get out of the way. And yes, look at the puck come down from Andy Moog. He thinks he has it. He usually controls them very well. Propp standing all alone, and you're not going to let Brian Propp miss many of those.
Brian Propp playing in his third All-Star game, gets his second All-Star goal. It's tied 1-1 with a minute 55 to go in the second period.
What happens when a defenseman joins the play? It sort of breaks up that defensive style back there because they're not sure who's going to go after him, who's not going to go after him. Everybody watched him, and Propp was left all alone.
But Naslin made a nice soft pass to set that play up. Sent back into the Campbell zone. It's stopped by Moog for Ramage. Leaves it for Gary Suter, the rookie. Suter. His pass off the stick of Glenn Anderson. Blocked by Bossy. Suter gets it again. Goes back for some safety behind the net. Gretzky's pass stolen by Bossy. Makes the move. Bossy has the puck. Looks around. Centers and knocked away by Moog. With Kirk Muller tied up in the crease, a whistle stops play. For a face-off, the net was knocked off the magnetic post. Kirk Muller was battling right in the crease looking for that setup from Bossy.
Mike Bossy, of course, making all those tricky little moves over on the far side, John. We see Bossy, and we talk about it a lot, where he plays so well without the puck, but boy, can he be magic with it.
It's interesting, when they hook away at Bossy, what he'll do is he'll let go of the stick with one hand, shake off that stick that's hooking away at him. There you see, now he's putting his hands back on the stick. Two people chase him. He reads the play and tries to set it up in front. Andy Moog read it pretty well as the Wales Conference player was in tight. Andy Moog, very aggressive when he plays goal. He's a small 5'9" player, goes by the nickname of Peach, and he loves to play aggressive out above the top of the goal crease, reads plays well.
He doesn't come out there, it's 2-1 because Muller was in behind him, but Moog realized that they were there and he went out and blocked the shot and took it away from him.
Muller continues to play well. The goal, by the way, for the Campbell Conference All-Stars at 17:56. That shot is saved by Moog. Prop gets the goal from Bork and Naslund at 17:56. The Wales Conference All-Stars goal, tying it at 1-1 with 1 minute to go in the second period. Wales 1, Campbell 1.
I think Sather wants to win this game too. He just had Messi on the ice to take that faceoff. Anderson is still on the bench.
Here comes Gartner with a nice feed for Pappas. Kick saved by Moog and a rebound cleared aside by Curry. Out comes Messier. Mark Messier fires it ahead, broken up nicely at the line by Ray Bork. Bork with a rush, fakes the shot. Bork controls, Curry on him. Now he's double-teamed by Fogelin. And it's worked free by Yari Curry. Curry sending it across to Lowe, and across comes Messier. Messier to Curry. Up over a stick with 25 seconds to go in the second period. Langway ties up Curry. Along the boards, it's worked free, stopped by Coffey. Gretzky in the corner. Feed for Coffey, just missed. 12 seconds to go in the second period. Each team has scored a goal. Nice feed for Anderson, breaking down. It's knocked away by Robinson. Larry Robinson comes back to make a good defensive play as the second period comes to an end. Well, it was scoreless for more than half the game. And then Tony Tanti, or just about half the game, Tanti scored. Let's look at that again.
It's a Gretzky opportunity here late in the period. As you see, Froese getting into position. A long shot by Gretzky. And Froese out there seeing it all the way. His defenseman let him see the shot, got the left pad on it.
You can certainly see how technically sound Froese is when he played his angles. He just moved across the crease very slowly to play the angle perfectly. The puck was rolling here when Gretzky shot it, and then it maybe even deflected. That makes it tough for a goaltender to play it. It's almost like a knuckleball going at you. But Bob Froese made the save.
End of two in the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game. Campbell Conference 1, Wales Conference 1.
Well, the Prince of Wales Conference team is Phil Esposito, the second leading scorer in NHL history. This big, rugged, and durable center iceman was a star for 18 years in the NHL. He played in nearly 1,300 games and was a star for the Boston Bruins and the New York Rangers. Espo had 717 goals, but had more assists than goals. And he was an expert at setting up the power play, as Bruin teammate Johnny Busick can attest.
Playing on a power play with Phil Esposito was quite an experience. We had probably one of the most potent power plays for many years, and he was a big factor. He was a man that could get in front of the net, take a position, get the puck, and score a goal. He could also win faceoffs, tell you where to stand, and he'd pull the puck back to win a lot of games that way. Phil was a great man.
Well, Phil was probably one of the toughest centers I ever played against. An awesome figure out there at a time when there wasn't many big players in the National Hockey League. He was a fellow who was 6'3", about 220 pounds. Just a completely dominant offensive-type player. Just awesome up in the ice.
Time remaining, 18 minutes and 7 seconds. Here comes Esposito. Fans, goal number 700 for Phil Esposito.
The totals speak for themselves. 18 years, many times an all-star, 1,590 points, second all-time in the NHL.
And here is Phil Esposito, one of the honorary captains tonight. Phil, you're the honorary captain of the Campbell Conference. When you went out on the ice and you skated around with Gordie Howe between periods, how did it feel?
You know what? I played, I don't know how many All-Star games I was fortunate enough to play in. The first one was a big thrill, Tommy. But this is a real big thrill for me. I it's because, you know, I've been retired for 5 years. I still love the game. I still feel part of it. And to be able to go out there on the ice and get the ovation I did from this crowd was something very, very special to me. probably, I was as nervous as a cat before the game. I couldn't believe it. I'm going, like I was getting ready for the game or something. But I enjoyed it tremendously. And I really have to thank the people, and I have to thank Howard Baldwin of the Whalers for and League for allowing me to do it.
I want to ask you one question. You've always been very honest and outspoken as a commentator on the Rangers telecast. A lot of it is being said about high-sticking. I had some comments today, and other people around the league had some comments. The league has to do something because there's too much high-sticking. Do you agree or disagree?
Well, I agree with you. I think the stick work, and I said it on the television, I think the stick work has been an increase. I've never seen anything like it in the last 4 or 5 years. I'm glad I didn't play with the kind of stick work that I see. And I got a reason for it, and people don't like the reason, and that's simple. Kids are protected. They wear face masks. They wear helmets. Consequently, they don't know enough, and they keep throwing a stick up at you and trying to hit you with the stick because it can't intimidate you and they can't hurt you. And the first thing you know, you get guys with the stick up. I think you're going to see everybody wearing face masks soon unless they curtail that. And I don't know how they're going to do that. I really don't know except for say, hey, no more helmets.
Well, let's hope they find a way. Phil, always a thrill chatting with you. Thanks for being with us.
Tommy, thank you very much.
Okay. Phil Esposito, second leading scorer in NHL history. We'll be back with more between periods in just a moment from the 38th NHL All-Star Game. NHL All-Star Game, and with me is Mr. John DeMuth, the General Marketing Manager at Chrysler Corporation. And of course, John, for those hockey fans that didn't know, and I don't think there are too many that don't know, Chrysler Dodge sponsored the first ever fan balloting across the United States to pick the starters for this All-Star Game, and I know Chrysler Dodge is very happy with the way it turned out.
Indeed we are. We're very proud to be associated with our hockey league. At Chrysler, we're very much dedicated to quality and to excellence. The hockey league means that in professional sports, and it's wonderful for us.
What have been some of the benefits, both for Chrysler Dodge and you think for the NHL fans as a result of this balloting?
Well, I think it's interesting that the fans themselves are picking the excellent players, the real quality players to play in this. It's unique, it's new, and it's working very well for everybody. So we're pleased to be associated with it.
With the obvious exception of the Edmonton Oilers, who I think anybody would guess would dominate any All-Star team, I think the fans have done a good job in picking a variety of players from a variety of teams.
Super job, and I think the league thinks so also.
I think it's actually really more representative than, say, the baseball All-Star battling, which oftentimes is nothing but a popularity contest.
Absolutely, and I think we'll continue in this format in the years to come. It works very well.
Chrysler Dodge is happy with it, with the format, and it's going to be this way for several years, we hope.
We're very pleased. You bet.
John, thanks for stopping by on our ESPN telecast, and we look forward to being associated with Chrysler Dodge and the NHL for several years.
My pleasure, Tom.
Okay. Mr. John DeMuth from the Chrysler Corporation, their general marketing manager. We'll be back with more from the 38th NHL All-Star Game in a moment.
See Austin's only continuous antique show at the Austin Antique Mall. 30,000 square feet of antiques, art, vintage clothing, oriental rugs, jewelry, glassware, and much more. Over 40 dealers under one roof, and there's never an admission charge. So if you're looking for antiques or a place to show them, you'll find it all at the Austin Antique Mall, where we still have lease space available. Open every day from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. except Tuesday. Come see us at 8822 McCann Drive, one block west of Burnett and 183 behind Town North Nissan.
What do the following people have?
And once again, we talked about Quebec's Mario Gosselin being acrobatic, and we talked about Grant Fuhr being the great athlete. How about Andy Moog now? He's a control type of goaltender, which means?
He's fairly technically strong. He likes to play up above the goal crease because he's small, and very seldom do you ever see Andy Moog let a bad goal in, even though he did let a rebound out when Prop scored there in the second period. But he very seldom defeats himself. He makes the players beat him with good shots.
Okay, now we've got a couple of goalie sticks. These are both from the Andy Moog collection. You can see this one here, but you've got a different stick that Andy uses.
Well, what happens with this stick here, this is the normal shaft where it comes out there. Now, Andy Moog uses something called a Curtis curve, Jim, and what it has here is a curve in it, and so his glove hand, the stick hand, holds onto the blade like that or the shaft like that, and it's got a curve, and what happens when he goes to handle a puck to shoot it, he's able to get more leverage and shoot the puck with a lot stronger force behind it. Plus, it's also curved up here in the shaft, and that does a couple of things. First of all, if the stick is lost and is laying on the ice, he's able to reach down and get his fingers underneath it and pick it up quickly. Plus, he says when he goes to shoot it with the stick, he's got a lot more leverage because of the curve here and the curve here.
This thing looks like your putter.
Andy Moog is very successful with this. It's a new style, and he likes it, and he's not afraid to try new ideas.
All right, let's, speaking of new ideas, get to the super slow-mo right now and watch some of the saves, first by Grant Fuhr. Let's take a look right here.
Grant Fuhr, again, The concentration on a goaltender is so important. Find the puck through traffic. Here he's going to find the puck through two or three different people, and he tries to keep his shoulders square to the puck. Now he's going to reach back because he has to fall. He was caught up in traffic there, and the concentration, how he's able to knock that puck out of the air, was amazing. Grant Fuhr had just a great half a game, and you look at his goals against average, 4.63 or whatever it is, and you say, geez, Grant Fuhr must not be having that good a year. But then he comes in and does these things. He makes big saves. He's just a real good goaltender.
Another one by Grant Fuhr, and as we do, the All-Star Game is a different kind of a game for a goalie because those good scores, the wingers and centermen, keep coming over the boards in waves, unlike a regular game when you get to that third and fourth line, the checking line.
They're not good scorers, of course. And also, in this type of game, not much hitting, so players can go in and make those good offensive plays without having the fear of being knocked down too much. Mike Gardner is a good goal scorer. He can't handle a puck here right away. Grant Fuhr, again, remember we talked about trying to keep the shoulders square to the puck. Well, even when he was falling back, he kept himself square. Grant Fuhr, he was real good.
And we talked about Mario Gosselin of the Nordiques being an acrobatic goaltender, even though he's got the bad knees. We'll take a look at one of the acrobatic-like saves that we've got. Let's go to the other end of the rink right now.
Well, this is, watch Kevin Lowe, number four here, is going to get the puck. He kicks it forward beautifully. It's a three-on-two setup. Look how he gets across in one stride. He didn't take and stutter step across that goal crease. It was one quick push off, and he was across. Again, we'll go down to the other end of the ice. Gardner follows the play up all the time. You'll see him get his own rebound here and get a shot towards the goaltender. Fuhr, Paul Coffey, I don't know if he wants to put a set of goal pads out or not. He's having trouble in there trying to block shots. Again, the concentration really working well for Grant Fuhr.
What's it like for a team to have two great goaltenders like Fuhr and Moog?
They just have so much confidence in their goaltending. And another thing that makes them good, I think, Moog and Fuhr, is the fact that they practice every day against some of the best players in the world, against their own teammates and Wayne Gretzky and Mark Messier, and that has to make them better. Their personal work habits are terrific, and that's why they play so well.
Well, you mentioned number 99, Wayne Gretzky. What makes an all-star? We'll try and show you right here. Watch the great Gretzky and some unbelievable stick handling.
He's got the puck on the stick, but he doesn't look down. He constantly is looking up. He's got great vision. He's trying to find the open man. Look, he's not looking down at all. He's hanging on to it, getting himself into position. Look how bent over he is when he skates, and he's in total control. He's going to go back the other way. He doesn't even look down. He's still looking up, trying to find somebody wide open. Now, when he makes this little pass here, it's going to go through the legs of Brian Trottier. He knows exactly where that pass is going. He didn't throw the puck away blind here. He waits, makes a play. Look at this, through the legs. Tricky little pass, and it sets up a good goal-scoring play. Lee Foglin is a defenseman that also plays with Gretzky in Edmonton. They're not afraid to join the play. Even though Lee Foglin is a defensive defenseman, he'll go up and join the play, get into the open position because they know Wayne Gretzky can pass the puck to them. He just continues to amaze people. He's got 104 assists already. Imagine that.
If there's some youngsters out there, J.D., that wanted to be like Wayne Gretzky, is that teachable, that kind of stick handling, or is it instinctive?
Well, it's instinctive, but he, again, we talked about work habits. He has an inner drive that's incredible. Glenn Sather has team meetings a lot of times when his team's not going well, and he says if he ever wants to find an example of somebody with good work habits, he always talks about Wayne Gretzky. Wayne Gretzky can float the rest of the season and win the scoring race, but he doesn't. He's got inner drive. He continues to play. Very seldom do you see him not play well.
Speaking of scoring, let's get to the first goal. This one by Tanti, of course, and it led 1-0. And here's from the overhead.
When Gosselin tries to make the save here, I think he overplayed it somewhat. I don't think he was quite set. And when he stuck his pad out to make the save, the blade and the toe of his skate lifted up, and the puck went right underneath. Gosselin had played so well, I'm sure he wasn't very happy with himself on this goal.
Here's another look, and you can see, watch the left blade.
There, he lifts it right up, right there, and the puck goes underneath it. He wanted to keep that flat to the ice. He was very unhappy with himself after the goal. I was watching his reaction, but those things are going to happen. He's played pretty well all year.
But the Campbell Conference comes back. Watch number 26 for the Philadelphia Flyers, Brian Propp, around the net. And, well, Paul Coffey had some problems.
Naslin sets it up to Bork. Now watch what happens here. Coffey is sort of stuck in between. What am I going to do? Am I going to block the shot, or am I going to try and get the guy beside the net? Brian Propp is a good goal scorer, positions himself well, and got the rebound nicely. Look at Coffey there. He doesn't know what to do. Go at the shooter or play Propp. Bad decision. You should have taken one person. He did not. And Andy Moog thought he had control of the puck. It slips away from him, and Brian Propp is standing right there and in the open side.
The one thing you goaltenders don't get in an all-star game is that man that clears out in front of the crease, the old lumber in the back, huh?
Lee Foglin was asking us before the game. He says, how tough are these games? Should I get in there and bump somebody? I don't know what to do. That's my game, is to go and hit people. And he went and asked Doug Wilson about it. And Lee Fogel, he might bump a few people before it's over.
Speaking of great games, we've got a great game coming up right after the All-Star game. It's number one-ranked North Carolina against second-ranked Georgia Tech. It's on tape delay. I'll tell you this. I won't tell you the winner, but it did go right down to the wire. That's coming up after the hockey game. We've got the third period of the NHL All-Star game live on ESPN next. It's been a dandy here at the sold-out Hartford Civic Center. The 38th NHL All-Star Game as our ESPN cameras take you inside the locker room. But right now, let's check in with SportsCenter for the latest going on in all the world of sports. And this update now with our Sharon Smith.
Hartford Civic Center, this is the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game. There was no scoring in the first period. Each team coming up with a goal in the second. And we are moments away from the start of the third period. The goal scorers in the second, Tony Tanti for the Campbell Conference, Ryan Propp for the Wales Conference, and we are just about set to go. The glamour, the glitter, and the action of the National Hockey League All-Star Game is coming to you from Hartford. It's being brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? By Sears. Come celebrate Sears' new century. See all the ways we've changed and all the ways we haven't. And enjoy Diet Coke. You're going to drink it just for the taste of it. We're in the Wales Conference locker room as they get set to take the ice. A little delay in the start of the third period because of between periods entertainment. Shots on goal in the second period. Wales Conference had 15, total 23. Campbell Conference had 11, total 17. Mickey, you like those shots in the locker room, don't you?
Oh, yes. You see Mike Ramsey down there, the Buffalo Sabres, he's chomping at the bit. Of course, the toughest thing for players in an All-Star game is all the distracted type things that they go through during the day. I mean, today was just an incredibly long day. They were on the ice for over an hour with the shootout and the one-on-ones and all the paraphernalia going on and the delays. We had a beautiful show here at the second intermission, some singing and all kinds of things, but the players just, they want to get it on with, get out there and get going and get the game going.
Well, things opened up a little bit in the second period. Here come the Wales Conference All-Stars toward the ice, and there is number 66, Mario Lemieux. And think back a year ago when Mario Lemieux was a rookie and he starred in the NHL All-Star Game in Calgary. He was just 19 years old last year, but Mario Lemieux, the NHL's most heralded rookie, made the 1985 All-Star Game a memorable one. Lemieux was quiet and shy in the locker room before the game, but on the ice, he rose above all others with two goals and an assist to lead the Wales Conference to a 6-4 win. Mario Lemieux, the MVP of the 1985 NHL All-Star Game. Who will be the MVP in this game? Grant Fuhr could get a few votes. He was outstanding, wasn't he?
I think Grant Fuhr would get a whole bunch of votes.
There is Mario Lemieux. This is his second season. Last season, he scored 100 points right on the button. This year, he is second to Wayne Gretzky in assists, having an outstanding season and leading the Pittsburgh Penguins into playoff position. He has become a true dominant player in the National Hockey League at only 20 years old.
No question about that, Sam. John, you look at that first half a period, or half the hockey game, rather, for Grant Fuhr. I'm pretty sure that in the voters' minds, that unless one of the offensive players come out here in the third period and does something very, very special, and that would mean probably at least a couple of goals and an assist or something, and just dominates the whole period, I think Grant Fuhr is going to be our player of the game, and he certainly deserves it the first 30 minutes that he played.
Don't forget, it was only a couple of years ago, back in 1983, when the Campbell All-Stars had that incredible third period when they scored six goals. Wayne Gretzky had four of them, and of course, they're capable of exploding at any time. It's been an enjoyable National Hockey League All-Star Game. Of course, the intensity really isn't there. There isn't a tremendous rivalry built up between conferences. And I wonder, John, if you think maybe they should go to an East-West designation for the conferences. What do you think? Would that help?
They're talking about all kinds of different formats. I'd like to see it go for 1 week, make it an event, enjoy games,
make the whole event a week-long type of play and really sell the game. The city of Hartford has done a wonderful job. They've treated everybody very well, but they've thought of different ideas. The Stanley Cup champions against an all-star team.
I don't think that would work nowadays. Too many teams.
Another one was having just the Canadian players playing against the rest of the league's players. In other words, players from Sweden, Finland, and the United States. That would be interesting.
Interesting. Again, you need a little tradition built up, and that hasn't really happened.
I have to agree. We looked at Curry a few minutes ago when he was skating around. He sends tapes back to his family in Finland, and his father's able to watch him play. I'm sure he'll send the tape of the All-Star game back over across the sea. Parents see him in the All-Star game. His family built up a library of tapes. He's had an awful lot to send over. A lot of good plays he's made over the years.
Third period underway. Here come the Campbell All-Stars. Glenn Anderson sending it ahead. Ray Bourque breaks up the play. Langway. Brian Propp. And Doug Wilson banks it off the boards to Wayne Gretzky. Cross ice. The open man is Glenn Anderson. Anderson checked by Bourque. Leaves the puck there. And Langway clears it out to Mats Naslund. Fourth-year man from Sweden, Mats Naslund, across the line against Doug Wilson, sends it behind the net, that's Poulin, his pass blocked, and Paul Coffey picks up the puck. Coffey, who had a 29-game point-scoring streak this season, Wayne Gretzky had 39.
They were both stopped in the same game, a game in Chicago, a 4-3 win by Edmonton. What a game that was.
Across the line comes Anderson, he's checked there by Larry Robinson, feeds Bourque, it's passed him, out comes Mike Bossy. Fossey, who scored his 1,000th point in January. That shot is gloved. Good shot by Trottier. And Andy Moog loving it, holding on. Mike Fossey smiling. A little talk at the side of the net.
Andy Moog's an interesting person. When he plays against people like Fossey and Trottier, he realizes how good they are, so he loves to stay high above the goal crease. You know, when he made that save, he followed that puck right into the glove.
Yeah, I was going to say, John, almost like a hitter in baseball, right, watching the ball come right to the bat. Look at Moog. He had his eye on it all the way, and he just followed it right directly into the trapper.
He stared it right into the glove, and that's the best way of doing it. Again, when you see goaltenders do that, you can pick up on their concentration. Andy Moog hasn't had much trouble with his concentration this year.
Midgecam is on the goal right behind Andy Moog, giving you the goaltender's view of the play. Andy Moog steers it around. A little over a minute gone by in the third period. Score tied 1-1. The Wales Conference All-Stars have won the last two All-Star games, 7-6 2 years ago, and 6-4 last year. Lemieux has the puck.
Fellas, I tell you, Glenn Taylor's into this. Again, he had Messier on the ice just for the faceoff in that defensive zone. As soon as the puck was out, he went over to the bench and changed for who was supposed to be out on the ice.
Goulet with a shot that sticks aside by Moog, and Ramage sends it around. Lemieux stops it. Threw it wide of the net, near side. Ramage again. It stopped. Goulet keeping it in the zone for the Wales Conference. Now Gary Suter sending it ahead, and out comes Wendell Clark. Pass off the skates of Dale Howardchuk. Mark Howe sending it across to Robinson. And across the line comes Lemieux. Lemieux looks around for the net. Gardner was tied up in front. Ramsey couldn't keep it in. Almost a break for Wendell Clark, and here he comes. Wendell Clark tried to stuff it in and was stopped by Froese.
Boy.
17:50 to go in the third period. It's still Campbell Conference 1, Wales Conference 1.
Mike Ramsey got trapped and only Larry Robinson was back, a 2-on-1. Robinson goes right over to the open man. Here, Wendell Clark is just he and the goaltender. It's a 1-on-1 confrontation. Robinson played it perfectly. He couldn't pass it. And Bob Froese just stood up against that goalpost, short side, covered it up nicely, Mickey.
Wendell Clark handles that puck perfectly at center ice. He's got a clean-cut breakaway because they were caught up. But Robinson, as you mentioned, just played the middle. He knew that Wendell was at a bad angle, and Froese just, that's it. So the goaltender takes the shooter, defenseman plays the pass, and that's all she wrote. No goal.
Well, that reach of Robinson, he looked like a tree standing here. There's no way that Clark was going to be able to move the pass across.
Wales Conference with the puck. Good forechecking by Dave Taylor of the LA Kings. Now Mike Bossy has the puck. Seven-time All-Star. Mike Bossy across the line. Trottier heads for the net. The pass deflected by Lowe. Trottier has it back for Kirk Muller. Trying to get out in front. He's tied up by Neil Broughton. Trottier drops it back in the corner for Muller. Second-year man of the New Jersey Devils. Kirk Muller is tripped up. And Kevin Lowe able to send the puck ahead. Dave Taylor taps it over to Neil Broughton of the Minnesota North Star. Taylor with a puck back to Broughton. It was deflected by Mike Ramsey. They were former U.S. Olympic teammates.
Trottier's pass is along the shelf, drops down to Bossy. Bossy gets it by Ogrodnik to Trottier, and he drives one, gloved head high by Andy Moog. Good shot by Trottier. A little over 3 minutes gone by in the third period, score tied 1-1. John Ogrodnik dropped it back, nobody there. Kept in by Turgeon. Now Ogrodnik is tied up with big Tim Kerr, and Ogrodnik wins the puck. Good play by John Ogrodnik as Paul Coffey comes out of the zone. Across the line, Tony Canty, who scored the only goal for the Whale for the Campbell All-Stars. Coffey missed. It's centered off the stick of Froese. Shot by Wilson off the blocker of Froese. It's still loose on the scramble, and it's still loose. Play by the Campbell All-Stars. Messier fans on it, and Kerr sends it around the board. Stopped by Wilson at the point. He's wide open. He shoots. Stick saved by Froese, and the rebound's up into the crowd.
Dougie Wilson with that big shot from the point.
Scramble in front.
Yeah, Froese could see it all the way. He did make a good save on it as they began to jam up in front of the net. But Dougie Wilson, of course, shoots that puck with the best of them, John, back there.
Oh, it's scary when he gets a hold of it. Bob Froese, we talked about his ability to stand up and read plays. He tries to play and control himself. Now he's not sure where the puck is. And don't think you can't touch that puck if it's above your shoulder. Tanti waits for it to come down smartly, yeah. And almost, but he tried to kick it into the net, didn't quite work out.
I think he thought for a moment, I'll take a whack at it, but over the shoulders, of course, it would have been taken away. He let it come down, and by that time, they had congregated in underneath Froese and covered up.
See the 31 on the shoulder of Bob Froese? That's the number of Pelle Lindberg. Pelle Lindberg, who died in the automobile crash back in November, and was honored by the fans and voted to the starting All-Star team of the Wales Conference All-Stars. This number being worn by the Philadelphia Flyers. Nice save by Andy Moog. Howe didn't get much on that shot, and it's knocked out of the zone. A little over 4 minutes gone by in the third period. With the score tied 1-1, and Doug Wilson of the Blackhawks with a nice sheet for Tanti. Drop pass taken by Savard, who's tripped up. Out of the zone, here's a clear breakaway for Sylvain Turgeon. Turgeon comes in. Turgeon beats it and went off his stick. It slid off his stick, and Moog was able to make an easy stop on a 2-on-none break. The hometown star, Turgeon, went in and lost control. Here they try again. Tanti has the puck behind the back pass. It's broken up by Robinson. Here comes Turgeon again. Turgeon drops it off this time. And they score!
Beautiful. Peter Stastny.
Peter Stastny trailing the play, and this time Turgeon decided to pass.
I think Turgeon was a little bit tired. He was trying to go to the bench. The next thing he saw is they were breaking away offensively again, and he just seemed to get the Campbell defense backing in, and he dropped it. There were three Wales players there, and he dropped it back to Peter Stastny, and good shot, John, a perfect shot in the top corner.
You know, Gretzky thought he was going to strip Stastny and head up the ice with a puck, but he didn't, and Stastny, I tell you, don't leave him alone. He was just left all wide open. He popped it up top over Andy Mould's shoulder with a great shot.
That's the perennial 40-goal scorer, who dropped down to 32 last season, has 26 in the regular season. He comes up with the go-ahead goal. It's 2-1 for the Wales Conference All-Stars. Their first lead in the game. Turgeon gets the roar of the crowd for the assist. And made up for that missed breakaway opportunity. Across the line from the Wales Conference, Matt Snazlitt with a puck against Ramage. Nice drop for Poulin, who shot it wide. Gary Suter plays the puck, 14:35 to go in the third period. 2-1 Wales Conference, the Eastern All-Stars. Across the line, Curry drops it off, picked up by Brian Propp. They go the other way, it's Lemieux. Mario Lemieux behind the back to Naslin. Man open in front with Bork to his block. Naslin with a nice speed and a stick save. Shot by Michel Goulet coming off
here
the bench.
Goes.
Here comes Gretzky. Gretzky across the line is bumped by Ramsey.
Uh-oh. Is he hurt?
He's slow getting up.
Sure is.
Michel Goulet has the puck. Gretzky is limping to the bench.
It looked like Ramsey stood him up straight at the blue line, and they collided, and he is hurt heading to the bench, and it looks like a bit of a knee problem.
I think it's even above the knee. He might even be in the thigh. Maybe some sort of charity horse, but he caught him pretty good.
13:56 to go, third period. The Wales Conference All-Stars leading 2-1.
Have a look at this check now that occurs at the blue line. Gretzky, here comes Ramsey across. Look at the right knee out there. Oh, boy. That's a very unexpected Wayne Gretzky to receive a check like that from Mike Ramsey, but You know, it's tough. Ramsey's that kind of a hockey player. He's a tough hitter. And sometimes you just can't hold yourself back out there. And Mike Ramsey came over. Gretzky not expecting to get hurt. Let's hope he's not seriously injured.
Gretzky sitting down on the bench after flexing the leg. Seems to be okay. That shot by Ramsey goes wide of the net. A penalty is upcoming.
Campbell.
A high sticking call has been made by Ron Wicks.
You know what happened? Kevin Lowe took a run at Ramsey. That's what happened. Emotions running a little bit high. Kevin Lowe went after Ramsey. Remember, Ramsey's the person that hit Gretzky. So the Edmonton Oilers blood sticking together.
Right now, let's check in with Tom Meese.
Thank you, Sam Rosen. I'm with the Honorable William O'Neill, Governor of the State of Connecticut. Governor, it's a big night for your state hosting this All-Star game.
Oh, it sure is. It's been a great 3 days bringing up to tonight, and it's a great game that we're seeing here tonight.
The city of Hartford also benefiting and getting some exposure around this country and Canada.
Indeed. Well, it's an international event, of course, and the best players in the world, in my opinion, are here playing tonight in Hartford, Connecticut, and the whole world should know about that.
You enjoying it?
I'm enjoying it. It's a great game.
Governor, thanks so much for stopping by.
Thanks, Tom. Nice to be with you.
Governor O'Neill, now let's go back to Sam Rosen.
Thank you, Tom. Kevin Lowe for high sticking at 6:14. The Wales Conference second goal was Peter Stastny from Turgeon and Robinson at 4:45. Second power play for the Wales Conference.
John hit it right on the nose. Kevin Lowe went after Mike Ramsey after the check against Gretzky and said, hey, you're not supposed to be doing that out here, and that's the way she goes.
Power play opportunity. Rail Ruotsalainen of the New York Rangers with the puck. Now it's Ramsey driving one from the red line all the way around the boards it goes. Stopped by Lemieux, trying to feed the open Tim Kerr, but it was intercepted in front. And it's 35 to go on the power play for the Wales Conference, leading 2-1 on the go-ahead goal by Peter Stastny. Ramsey's feed ahead for Goulet, drops it in the Campbell zone, stopped by Moog for Wilson, who drives it all the way down.
Next Sunday, the Oilers are in Buffalo. ESPN's going to carry that game. There could be a little bit of a rematch coming with that Gretzky-Ramsey situation.
They'll remember. Here's Markow on the rush. Gretzky is back. We'll see if he's moving fluidly. Watch that carefully. That back pass is intercepted nicely by Curry. Hits Gretzky. Gretzky goes in against Robinson, looking for Coffey. He shot it wide. Coffey still has the puck. Takes it back to the defenseman, Rob Ramage, with 50 seconds to go on the penalty to Kevin Lowe.
The Oilers lead the league in regular season play in shorthanded goals, Sam. You can see why. Paul Coffey can join the play. Gretzky is a great penalty killer, not only an offensive player, but a good penalty killer to read plays. Curry hit him. Look at it again. Gretzky's got his head up, looking. He's trying to time this beautiful pass across to Coffey, and it was in his skates. Didn't quite get enough of it. It was in tight to his body, and he couldn't get the forehand of his blade on the puck.
Right off the tip of the stick, actually, in the feet, you're right. But, you know, you've seen the Oilers quite a bit of times, John. Anytime you want to get Wayne Gretzky going, as he receives a check, and if he's not hurt, look out. And he was starting to fly out there then, or, you know, a few occasions where he's been booed in Edmonton, you know what he's done. He just comes out there and says, I'll tell you what, grab the puck and go and make it happen.
40 seconds to go. The penalty to Kevin Lowe, 12:20 to go in the third period, and the whistle stops play as the puck flies over the boards. Into the penalty box.
See the two Oilers now, Gretzky and Curry out there. Messier a few moments ago, the Oilers last year setting a record for shorthanded goals, over 30 of them in the season. And these guys are dangerous at all times. Anderson, another one, John, who's got that great speed. And they look offense, even while they're killing penalties.
They anticipate plays. They anticipate loose pucks. They think offense as soon as they have a chance to control the puck. And that is basically called the transition game. They're very good at it.
Gretzky seems to be struggling just a little bit. Comes off the ice. And Howardchuk comes back on.
You know, it's tough. In an All-Star game, you've got 12 forwards picked to the team. You've got four lines, and the coaches normally will stay with the four lines. And it's tough to get into the hockey game because you only get on the ice every three, four, or five minutes. You get four or five shifts a period, if that.
Here's Howardchuk with the puck, throwing it through. And it's picked up by Robinson. 25 seconds to go on the Wales Conference power play. They lead 2-1 with 12:05 to go in the third period. Oh, sending it back in the corner. Doug Wilson battling with Mats Naslund. Wilson falls down, sandwiches the puck between his legs and holds it for a faceoff. The outstanding defenseman of the Chicago Blackhawks, Doug Wilson, playing a little more defensively this season, being very solid on the back line and not scoring as many goals as he used to.
Well, Dougie struggled in the early going of this 85-86 season. A moment ago, you saw Naslund try to use the end board, John. This morning, a few of us went out to skate just before the teams went on with Gordy and Phil, and we were out there. These are strange boards in Hartford. They really have a big kick, almost like a pool table bounce, and they've tried to use that several times here tonight.
Funny bounce. Goaltenders are aware of that. They will go at morning skates, and they'll test the boards themselves. Dougie Wilson's an interesting guy. When they played the Canada Cup in 84, Glenn Sather called him the best defenseman on the team. So he's a quality person, and they knew in Chicago that he was going to come back and play well. In the second half, he's really picked up the game, and that's one reason why the Blackhawks have had such a good second half. I was going to say
that he struggled early, but he certainly seems to get getting his game back in gear now, and the Hawks have been hot. Really hot lately.
Kevin Lowe about to return. He's back. The teams are at full strength as Messier carries in. His backhander deflects over the top, and Lemieux picks it up. Teams are back at full strength with 11:35 to go in the third period. Wales Conference and the White leading the Campbell Conference 2-1. Lemieux picks up the puck. Lemieux to Coulet across the line. Cross-ice pass misconnection with Tim Kerr. Messier throws it back to Rob Ramage. Ramage carries it off the boards and out of the zone. Langway almost lost it. Back into the Campbell zone where Andy Moog stops it for Lee Fogelin, whose father played in the NHL All-Star Game in 1950 and 51. Lee Fogelin playing in his first NHL All-Star Game. Kirk Muller sending to Ray Bourque. Coming down across the line with Bossy heading to the net. The feed for Bossy. He's tied up by Fogelin. Puck behind the net. Muller digging for it. The Trottier is deflected across. Here's Bourque with low on him. Muller sends it around to Trottier, looking to find Bossy in front. He's checked by Neil Broughton. Good play by Broughton, breaking up that potential goal-scoring chance. Taylor across the line to Ogrodnik. John Ogrodnik of the Detroit Red Wings sending it into the near corner where Broughton plays it. Back to Ogrodnik, poked away by Robinson. 10:25 to go in the third period. It's 2-1. The Wales Conference All-Stars leading the Campbell Conference All-Stars. Muller to Trottier. Stopped by Moog behind the net. Picked up by Glenn Anderson. Bossy meets him out in center. Played by Ramsey. Mike Ramsey of the Buffalo Sabres. Ramsey took 23 stitches in his right ear after the game with the New York Rangers last Friday night. He went down to block a shot by Willie Huber, and his teammate Steve Dykstra skated over his ear. He took 23 stitches. He's in the game tonight. Gretzky lost it to Ruotsalainen. Poulin deflected. Gretzky gets it back, but gave it away, and Ruotsalainen has it. Now Gretzky picks up the puck. Tied up in center by Naslund. Pokes it over to Curry. Curry across with a drive that's blocked by Ruotsalainen. Pokes the puck into the corner. Ruotsalainen drops it back behind the net. Poulin recovers. Dave Poulin of the Philadelphia Flyers, the captain of the Flyers, lost the puck. Here's Anderson with a shot blocked nicely in front by Ramsey. He's one of the good shot blockers in the league. That shot goes wide by Prop.
He has a problem with rocket blocking shots this time of year, Sammy. He says his feet get sore. This time of year. So many this time of year. Mid-season. It's tough on him, he said.
Howe throwing it across. Picked up by Gretzky, but Messier's offside. 8:58 to go, third period of the 38th NHL All-Star Game. Wales Conference leading the Campbell Conference 2-1. Jim Kelly and Tom Meese here at the 38th National Hockey League All-Star Game. Hope you're enjoying it on ESPN. Sylvain Turgeon clearing his zone. Peter Stastny with a go-ahead goal, drops it off. Gartner lifts up his stick. He's checked from behind by Messier. Gartner loses again. And out come the Campbell Conference All-Stars. Denny Savard bears down, drops it to Messier, and gets it back. Savard poke-checked away. Good play by the goaltender, Bob Rose. Panty takes the puck back. Panty has the Campbell goal to Messier behind the net. Savard's in front. The pass to Wilson. Saved by Rose. I don't know how he found it. There were two players in front of him.
Dougie Wilson one-timed that one in a nice setup in the back of the net by Candy. And I'm not sure that may have just hit, but the key is he was in the right spot.
He's schooled by Bernie Perrant, the former great goaltender with the Philadelphia Flyers. And technically, most Flyer goaltenders are always very strong.
Mark Hunter gets rid of the puck to Lee Fogelin. Kept in by Muller. Pass in the slot to Big Tim Kerr. Throws it off the end boards where Kevin Lowe plays it with 7:45 to go in the third period. 2-1, Wales Conference leading it. Wendell Clark goes cross-ice to Savard. Blocked at the line by Muller. Muller looks around. Pass deflects into the Campbell zone. Randy Moog puts it back into the corner. Vogelin fires out of the zone. Rod Langway of the Washington Capitals recovers. Howerchuk goes for the puck. Hawerchuk comes in. Dale Hawerchuk centers across. Langway did a good job on Wendell Clark. And here comes Lemieux. Has Bork on the right. Lemieux across. Centers. It's deflected in front. Taken back by Kevin Lowe. Kept in the zone by Lemieux. He shoots. Leg save by Moog. What a shot by Lemieux. Hawerchuk has the puck. Hawerchuk pass off the skates of Wendell Clark. Langway plays the boards to Bossy. Now Langway gets it back. And tapped out of the zone. Ryan Trottier picks up the puck and comes across. It's intercepted. Cleared out by Broughton. Now it's Wendell Clark with the puck. 19-year-old Wendell Clark, whose shot is blocked. It's loose in front. The Wales Conference All-Stars able to clear the zone with 6:35 to go in the third period. Wales Conference leading the Campbell Conference 2-1. Gary Suter with a puck. Fires it up the middle of John Ogrodnik. Ogrodnik tries to split the defense, couldn't do it. Rutsalainen takes the puck back for the Wales Conference All-Stars. That pass blocked and picked up by Trottier, who hits Brian Propp. Propp across the line against Suter. Propp looks around. Back to the point. Rutsalainen wrists it toward the net. Saved by Moog. Brian Trottier was in front looking for a deflection. Rutsalainen with a puck and 6 minutes to go in the third period. Rutsalainen with some room. He's tripped up by Ramage. Ogrodnik able to steer it around to Paul Coffey. Well, under 6 minutes to go in the third period. Puck sent down and icing is called. 5:46 to go, third period. The Clarence Campbell All-Stars trailing the Wales Conference All-Stars 2-1.
On V6 Thunderbirds.
Now, look at some of the action again. We've got back and forth action with both sides with 5:46 to go. The shot coming from the point. Andy Moog making the stop there again. Fortunately, there was a Campbell player there to take it out of harm's way, or that would have made it 3-1 with the wide open side. But pretty scrappy right now. Both teams checking fairly well.
Nice shot by Rutsalainen from the point with Trottier in front.
It looked like he tried to time it where it was going to be deflected. He took a little bit, as they say, off the shot. In other words, he let up a little bit on it, Sam.
Here's Wayne Gretzky throwing it ahead. It's blocked by Larry Robinson. Robinson has played a quiet but very solid game on defense for the Wales Conference All-Stars. 2-1 score. Wales Conference leading it. Go-ahead goal by Peter Stastny, assisted by Sylvain Turgeon here in the third period, and Larry Robinson. 4:45 in the third period. Puck behind the net. Wales Conference controlling. Worked out of the zone by Matt Schnaslin to Propp. Here comes Poulin. It looks like a two-on-one developing just behind Poulin. Gretzky lets it go. It's cleared out of the zone. Here's Glenn Anderson coming in against Robinson. Centered for Curry. It's off his skate and Poulin recovers. Clears the zone. Coffey sending it across to Curry. Yari Curry centers and Poulin breaks it up. 4:50 to go in the third period. Poulin being hooked from behind by Gretzky is holding his stick. He couldn't get free. And Gretzky comes away with a puck. Checked by Turgeon, who pulls him down. Penalty call.
Not going to like this one. Gretzky might have gotten a call him over to go this time. The Wales get it as Gretzky is hauled down.
Power play coming up for the Campbell All-Stars. We'll be right back.
Steady Rider.
One of the most popular shocks in America. Designed for thousands of miles of smooth, steady ride over all kinds of roads. It's Sears Steady Rider Shock Absorber. One more way we install confidence at Sears. Right now, save $10 on Steady Rider air adjustable shocks. Just $59.99 a pair, plus installation. But hurry, this sale is on now.
There's more for your life
at Sears.
Here's the turn of events. Watch Gretzky just control Poulin's stick here. He's got his stick in front of Poulin's stick. You call that hooking, you might not want to call it hooking. I don't know, it's a discretionary call. And then it turns around and goes back the other way where it definitely was a hook. Turgeon
took a hold of Gretzky, pulled him down to the ice. Gretzky draws more penalties than probably anyone in the entire National Hockey League. Watch Turgeon. Gretzky's going to move aside from him. He's going to reach up. Watch that. He pulls him right down with the blade of the stick.
Well, hooking can be called hooking any part of the body or the equipment, really, on the stick. But Gretzky seemed to just have the sticks crossed to halfway down to the shaft. And, of course, the fans here wanted the penalty called against him.
Hartford, Sylvain Turgeon gets 2 minutes for hooking at 15:22. Second power play for the Campbell All-Stars. They're 0-for-1. Across the line, Howarchuk with a feed for Tanti. His centering pass was blocked. Tanti gets it back to Savard. And a Savard with a back pass. And a shot by Ramage, saved by Froese. He gets up and the shot went wide. Ramage tried to put it in the corner, but wound up putting it over the glass. Some of the crowd stopping play with 4:07 to go in this third period and a minute 30 to go on the penalty to Sylvain Turgeon.
Okay, when you're on the power play, your defensemen have to try and get to the middle of the ice for a better angle to shoot the puck. Watch the goaltender Froese here have some trouble trying to get up to get his balance. Having a little bit of trouble, but he knows the puck's out of harm's way. Didn't panic at all.
I've seen you do that a couple of times, John.
Still skate guard trick.
Only I couldn't get back up. That was my problem.
Denny Savard out there on the power play. Denny Savard today is 25 years old.
Ramage is the one who goes down on the seat of his pants. Campbell All-Stars with a power play. Howarchuk has the puck. Messier gets in the zone. Messier lost control. Langway tried to knock it away. Gretzky has it. Gretzky cross ice to Howarchuk. Now the feed to Savard. Savard trying to come out in front centers. It's loose in front. Froese trying to smother it and does.
What happened in front there is Messier's big and strong and he was looking for a loose puck, but Langway, instead of pushing him aside, grabbed a hold of Messier's stick with his hand, and Messier was unable to get a hold of the loose puck. Well, watch in front. Langway's going to go right at Messier and reach down and grab his stick. See him grab the stick right there? No way Messier's going to be able to find a loose puck.
That's what happens sometimes when you go too close to the net in front of the goaltender. You let the defenseman, you're doing the job for him because it's easy for him to cover you. Sometimes those forwards like to stay out 15, 20 feet, and they force the defenseman. He's got them all tied up, as you can see. They force that defenseman to leave his position. If he does, then it's open for another forward to sneak in behind him.
You know, camera's showing you the moves, the sneaky moves of the big defenseman in front.
Well, Leif Hoglund says, listen, the guys are so big and strong now, how am I going to push them out in front of the net? Instead, I'll just grab a hold of their stick. They can't score, and I save my energy. And it makes sense to me.
The guy that'll figure out, it'll be Leif Hoglund.
Here comes Lemieux across the line. He's held from behind in a penalty call. Big Mario Lemieux is held from behind, and it will be evened up. Marc Messier will go with 52 seconds left in Turgeon's penalty and 3:29 to go in the third period. They'll be skating four aside.
That's the second time tonight that Big Lemieux has drawn a penalty against the opposition. Look at him use the body, the left knee, the left arm. He puts it up there and forces the opposition to grab a hold of him.
Messier took one hand off the stick. And when you do that, you naturally want to reach out and grab people.
Yep.
And look at him keep that puck in control and out ahead of him. He's still trying to get the job done. Messier is very, very strong himself. Lemieux kept his balance. That's quite amazing. But Messier had taken it one arm, one hand off the stick and reached out and got caught for holding.
Trottier got a good backhander off that just slid wide. So they'll skate four aside. And in 50 seconds, the Wales Conference All-Stars leading 2-1 will have a power play advantage. Firing it ahead, intended for Savard. He's got any centers in front, but coming back is Ray Bourque to break up the play. 3:10 to go in the third period. Wales Conference leading 2-1. Doug Wilson has it. 30 seconds left in the penalty to Sylvain Turgeon.
With each team having one man in the penalty box, it opens up the ice somewhat. It's a lot more fun to watch.
I wish you could tell what teams that are ruled
right
by you and me both.
And here's Gretzky with a shot. Hit the post. Coffey has it. Coffey centers. That shot, they score. Wayne Gretzky. And it's tied. There's the 4-on-4, and Gretzky scores to tie it 2-2.
It's the Edmonton Oilers that were complaining mostly about not having that situation.
Well, I agree with you, John. I don't like the rule myself, and I wish you could see more of this kind of activity. This is an even-strength situation. Still 14 seconds left in the Turgeon penalty, and Gretzky, after knocking it off the pipe, finishes it off.
What happens is Bob Froese is going to go back. That's the shot that hits the post, but he doesn't know where the puck is or who's out front. Watch him go across to his right, and he stays down low. He can't see it, and the puck was shot up over top of the shoulder.
I don't know if that one may have hit the pipe as well when it went in. There's the shot. Good look at that one from behind Gretzky. Froese followed it then, and as you say, John, he did duck down, and Gretzky got it up a feet from Coffey, and I think it might have caromed off the other goalpost. Boy, Gretzky isn't going to miss
that often, and we're tied at two.
Here's Savard, and in 5 seconds, the Wales Conference All-Stars will have a power play. Score now tied 2-2, 2:35 to go in the third period. If the score is tied at the end of regulation time, they will not resurface the ice. They'll play a five-minute overtime. Sudden death overtime. And here comes Brian Popp. Popp is in. He scores! Well, maybe we can forget about that overtime talk.
Mickey, you can tell a goal scorer when he goes in on a breakaway and he's in total control. What Popp does here is fake. He's going to shoot the puck three or four times. He put the blade of his stick over top of the puck in the air and faked it back and forth. Finally got Moog to commit himself somewhat, and then Prop went in and finished the job.
I don't know how the Campbell Conference got caught the way they did, but there was absolutely nobody in the middle of the ice. There's the feed from Robinson. Look at the defensemen are coming up. It looked like they thought they had possession, and there's two Wales guys all in alone. Nobody in the middle of the ice, and Brian Prop with a good move just slammed it underneath the stick of Andy Moog.
Bergeron had returned. It's a power play goal for the Wales Conference All-Stars, who regained the lead 3-2. Gretzky's goal was his eighth All-Star goal from Coffey and Savard at 17:09. Puff's goal comes 29 seconds later. And it's 3-2 Wales Conference with 2:10 to go in the third period. Ray Bourque has the puck. Teams at full strength. Ramage blocking it. He's checked by Muller in the corner. Picked up by Suter. Broughton sends it to Ramage with 2 minutes to go in the third period. So just as I started to set up the overtime situation, Brian Prop wipes it away. Ramage has it at the point. He drives one toward the net, hit the outside of the net. Ogrodnik, bumped by Bourque. Very light bump. An excuse me bump. Out of the zone it comes with a minute 35 to go. We'll keep our eyes on Andy Moog to see if and when he heads for the bench for an extra skater. For the Campbell Conference All-Stars trailing the Wales Conference 3-2. Wales Conference trying to make it three straight wins over the Campbell Conference. Doug Wilson has the puck with a minute 20 to go. In comes Howerchuk. He's pulled down. Penalty save shot. Was made by Froese.
Penalty or penalty shot?
Boy, that just called the penalty. It's a penalty and a power play coming for the Campbell Conference All-Stars. The Wales leading it 3-2.
Just for the fun of it, just for the fun of it, the number one of it, Diet Coke. Just for the style of it, just for the oomph of it, the ripple, the taste of it, Diet Coke.
A perfect pass by Dougie Wilson over to Howerchuk. I think there could have very easily been a penalty shot called here. Langway was out of play, couldn't get him. And he's hooked right down to the ice. He was away, not quite completely, but just the end of that stick with the hook by Gartner.
You know what they're going to say, Mick? They say he did get a shot on goal. Maybe that's why there was not a penalty shot, but it very easily could have been called. 1:15 remaining here in the third period. This is going to be an interesting setup right now.
Gartner for hooking at 18:45. And Andy Moog is heading for the bench. They want to get a sixth skater on and make it a 6-on-4, but he can't get out. Wilson recovers. Good pressure by Poulin. Across the line comes Gretzky, looking to set it up. Nice feed for Coffey. His shot is blocked. He gets the rebound. 1 minute to go. Shot by Gretzky at the outside of the net. 6-on-4 advantage now as Poulin has the puck, tries to dump it out. Wilson stops it, feeds Coffey with room. Coffey goes cross ice. That shot is stopped by Froese. The rebound. They score. Dale Howerchuk, it's a power play goal, and we're tied 3-3.
They had the goaltender out. They got the six skaters out there. Unbelievably devastating. The play of these guys controlled the puck at the point. Of course, it is a 6-on-4, the two-man advantage. What are you going to do? 43 seconds left, and John, there were three Campbell guys in that crease area when they centered it right underneath the goaltender.
They outnumber the other team. Yep. What a save Froese have made on Curry right there. And then the puck goes in front. Everybody's watching the puck instead of trying to pick up on some of the opposition players. Finally, Howerchuk was able to, just before he got past the goal line, put it in. Coffey's pass across here to Curry is a set play that the Edmonton Oilers used a lot. Then they just flooded the front of the net and they got the goal that they wanted.
That's the one-timer that John's talking about. Look at that happy bench, I'll tell you.
Sater is happy about it. The rest of the guys,
they want to win these hockey games. Glenn Sater, as I mentioned before, has lost two straight. He wants a win.
Okay, Sam.
Can
back
I tell
to you
overtime?
Finish
okay.
The story on overtime.
If it ends this tied in regulation time, they'll won't resurface the ice. They'll take a break, play a 5-minute sudden death overtime. If it's still tied after that, they'll resurface the ice and then come out and play a full sudden death overtime period. So that's the story with 15 seconds to go in regulation. Puck with a drive that's wide. Poulin to the far side with 10 seconds to go in regulation time. Puck on the wraparound is pulled down by Coffey. No call made. 5 seconds to go in regulation time. And for the second time in NHL All-Star history, we're going to overtime.
Well, we finally got us some offense.
They saved their best for last at the end of regulation time. It's 3-3. Back with more All-Star action in a moment.
Gaining ground on my future. Making new strides every day. Infantry in the Army Guard is showing me the way. I feel home where I wanna be, guarding all that's close to me. The Guard is America at its best.
What do the following people have in common? John Henry Falk, Madeline Murray O'Hare, former Attorney General Ramsey Clark, Dr. Spock, former CIA official John Stockwell, Daniel Ellsberg, Black Power advocate Stokely Carmichael, Nobel Prize winner George Wald. Well, they've all appeared on Alternative Views, Wednesday at 10:30, Sunday at 7.
Just for the fun of it, just for the fun of it, the number one of it, Diet Coke. Just for the style of it, just for the overflow, for the taste of it, Diet Coke.
In a battlefield, you need horsepower, firepower, people power. That's teamwork.
Moving tank, back front, shoot down.
This team uses a computer, thermal sight, laser rangefinder.
Ah!
Yeah! All that you can. We win, the whole tank wins, the whole team wins, not just one person.
Find your future in the Army.
Take a look at the goal that tied this game at 19-17.
To try to outnumber the opposition in front of the net, Dale Hawerchuk just finally finds a loose puck as Bob Prosser had made a great save, but it took himself out of the play. And the reaction by Hawerchuk, the reaction by the entire bench of the Campbell Conference, look at the net, jubilation. Jack Rally over on the left is the honorary coach, Glenn Sather.
Look at Sather Clark. Doesn't want to win too much, does he?
Young Wendell Clark, yeah. He's just going crazy out there.
It's got to be a thrill for the rookie.
In the third period, Peter Stastny at 4:45 from Turgeon and Robinson made it 2-1 Wales. Then Gretzky at 17:09 from Coffey and Savard tied it. Propp at 17:38 from Robinson made it 3-2. Hawerchuk from Coffey, and they say Savard. We thought it was Curry on the assist, but right now it's Savard made it 3-3. And here we go with 5 minutes, sudden death overtime, or sudden victory overtime if you win. It's sudden victory. If you lose, it's sudden death. Back goes Mark Messier with a puck. And across to Rob Ramage. Now Yari Curry with Kevin Lowe. Lead for Messier offside on the play. 24 seconds gone in this 5-minute overtime period. And again, if they are tied at the end of the 5 minutes, they'll resurface the ice and will play a full overtime period. Could go as long as 20 minutes.
25-year-old Mark Messier, it's hard to believe he's in his seventh year with the Edmonton Oilers, and he's just 25 years old. He's got to be the physically the most strong center iceman in the league right now, I'd have to say. You know, it used to be Brian Trottier, but times change, and you take a good look at Andy Moog.
Well, overtime work for Moog and Crows.
Andy Moog's dad was a goaltender, played for represented Canada, world championship play in years past, and his son's
carrying on the tradition pretty well.
Don't forget, immediately following the All-Star game, the big college basketball game between North Carolina and Georgia Tech. Loose puck in front. Number one, North Carolina. Number two, Georgia Tech. That's coming up right here on ESPN immediately following the conclusion of the 38th National Hockey League All-Star game. Panthe centering. It's loose in front. Robinson able to clear the zone. 1 minute gone by in this five-minute sudden death overtime period. Paul Coffey has the puck. Take it away. And in comes Michel Goulet. Goulet shoots, save is made. Goulet the rebound. And it's underneath Andy Moog as Stastny was poking at it.
You could just feel what was going through Paul Coffey's mind, Johnny. He gave the puck away. He mishandled it. Had trouble with it. It got in his feet. And in goes Goulet all alone. One-on-one. Moog made two or three saves even on the rebound. And Peter Stastny tried to jam it underneath Andy Moog after he was down. But I could just imagine Coffey thinking, oh, no, please, Andy, come to my defense.
Trecce reads the play pretty well, and Trecce looks around, is nowhere to pass it immediately, so Andy goes by himself.
Goulet,
yes, good play by Goulet. Moog tried to cover it up immediately. Watch Stastny, he's going to jam underneath. They want to end this right away.
You know, I think that Goulet sensed that Coffey was right on his tail trying to make up for the error and had to let the puck go earlier. He might have had himself a deke on Andy Moog.
Goulet, one of the premier goal scorers in the league. You won't see that happen too often. One-on-one, he is likely to win. 3:45 to go in this five-minute overtime period. Gamble Conference All-Stars, Neil Broughton sending it in. Ristolainen plays it off the board, poking it ahead. Kept in by Dave Taylor. This is Howard Chuck. Back to Taylor. Backhander went wide. Mike Gardner sends out Peter Stastny. Stastny across the line, overskates the puck, took himself offside with 3:28 to go in this overtime period.
I tell you, fellas, we're seeing a little bit of extended effort now. They're really starting to pour it on. Full strength, all ahead, full here in the overtime to try to end it. Peter Stastny, just incredible statistics his first 5 years in the National Hockey League. Never, as Sam pointed out, never been under 100 points. What a hockey player.
Man from Czechoslovakia, now a Canadian citizen. Was the NHL Rookie of the Year when he broke in. This is the look from the midget cam. Here comes Goulet on the breakaway.
Look at Coffey in the back. He's really trying to get back there, and I think Goulet sensed it and let the puck go early. Shot it right into the midsection, Andy Moog.
3:28 to go in this overtime period. And if it remains tied, they'll go to the locker room for a rest. They'll resurface the ice, and they'll play another overtime period. Perhaps a full 20-minute overtime. Kevin Lowe winds it around. Throws, stops it behind the net. Mike Ramsey. Checked by Howard Chuck. Ramsey's pass deflected off the corner boards. Ogrodnik finds the puck. He's checked by Ramsey again. Now it's Taylor. Dave Taylor, number 18. Taylor of the LA Kings throws it on goal. It's knocked aside by Froese with 2:55 to go in this overtime period. Howard Chuck keeps it in. There's Ramsey to intercept. Out of the zone. Wales Conference. Lemieux tapping it ahead. He's held up by Messier. That time Messier used his strength on Lemieux in center ice. 2:40 to go. Kevin Lowe. Knocked down by Lemieux. Lemieux comes back. He's sandwiched. Hoglan got him on one side. And he's held by Ogrodnik from behind. Driven in off the corner boards with 2:25 to go. Stopped by Turgeon. Moog leaves it for Messier. He's checked by Poulin. Out of the zone it comes to Gretzky. Gretzky with Bork back. Just dumps it in for Curry. Langway there to break up the play. Stolen by Gretzky. Gretzky comes in. He drives one. Saved by Froese. With 2:08 to go in overtime, Bob Froese used the glove to make the stop.
Wayne Gretzky anticipates so well. He read the play that Langway was going to fire the puck around the boards. He did it blindly, and Gretzky was there to read the play, and he took that play and turned it into a goal-scoring chance.
It was from a bad angle, but he decided, I'll let it go from here anyway and see what happens. He does score a lot of bad angle goals. A moment before that, though, John, the lead pass to Curry. Only those two guys can do it. Gretzky just a little feathery pass up over the stick. And there was Curry to take the perfect feed in on the offense.
Jack Riley thought it was going in. Want to take this time to thank our top statistician, Barry Watkins, for helping us out on this All-Star game effort. 2 minutes to go in this five-minute overtime period. Knocked into the zone, across the line comes Bossy. Bossy feeder cross, Trecce scores!
Brewers
went off the skate, too. They're going to allow it, though. It's going to be an overtime win, and I'm pretty sure that went off of Trottier's right skate, John.
Wales Conference has won it 4-3 at 3:05 of overtime as Brian Trottier, set up by his teammate Mike Bossy, scores the game winner.
It was a 2-on-1, and they just took complete control of the situation. Bossy turned the speed on here as soon as he read that it was going to be a 2-on-1. He already knows Trottier's there. Look at him turn the speed on, and a simple little pass across. Messier did his best to get back to Trottier. Couldn't get there in time. Bossy, Trottier do it again. And the winning goal scored by Brian Trottier.
Trottier trying to shoot, fanned on it. It was directed in, but not an intentional
That's right.
direction.
That's
so
exactly
the goal
right, yeah.
is allowed to stand.
Yeah, I don't know whether he might have gotten his stick back on it again, but it definitely hit that right skate and went towards the opening. But as you point out, it wasn't intentionally directed towards the net. The goal stands, and the players now line up at center ice, and traditional handshake.
Mike Bossy, something when he just smells an opening, he loves to take an advantage of
but
it.
But the two of them, they read each other so well, Bossy and Trottier, for so many years. And there you see the traditional handshake. That is, of course, great to see. It's been an outstanding all-star time here in the city of Hartford. They've done such an outstanding job with the all-star game. Next year, it will be in Quebec City. Brian Trottier with the game winner at 3:05. Of overtime, getting the game winner. Here it is again.
Well, Bossy knew right at the blue line, he beat Marc Messier. Messier was a little bit behind the play, and Bossy smelled it. He went in the opening, knew that Trottier, his teammate, was with him. And there's not much the Oilers or the Campbells can do about it. Coffey just plays in the middle, and there's 61, who had to give up 19 because of seniority to Robinson.
You were right. It was the Oilers. Coffey and Moe, nothing they could do about it. Final score of the 1986 All-Star Game. The Wales Conference making it 3 in a row, winning in overtime, 4-3.
There's a sporty vehicle that offers you so much variety, it fits right in with today's active lifestyles. The tough Ford Bronco 2. It's a hit with the jet set and the wet set, the trail set and the sail set, the tow set, the snow set, the angler set and the wrangler set. Ford Bronco 2. Around town or up in the mountains, you know it's built tough. The best built American trucks are built Ford tough.
Give me a light.
No.
Bud Light.
If you just ask for a light beer,
thanks.
You never know what you'll get.
Nah.
Give me a light.
Nah, Bud Light.
Yo, so if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste, don't just ask for a light beer.
Give me a light.
Ask them to bring out their best.
Bud Light.
Bud Light. Because everything else is just a light.
Zicky's Work Clothes. It's the best-selling work set in America because it's made of the heaviest, toughest fabric in America, fortified with Fortrell. We don't have to knock out the competition. We wear them out. Dickies, the heavyweight champion of the work. Dickies makes everything in work clothes. But who says you have to work in them?
Hilton means hotel. 1-800-HILTONS is the only number you need to know.
Who played the first half of the game and shut out the Wales Conference All-Stars, is named the MVP. So the goalie finally won out, Big John.
He was great. Let's not kid ourselves. There was a lot of good players out there and made some real good plays. But Grandfjord kept his team in it. He had a lot of work. And you saw the ability of Grandfjord. I think he's really taken back by it. He's a very shy person. And doesn't say a lot of words. He's quite a character. I really feel good for him because he's come back from injuries this year. And he's played well for his hockey club. And usually it's Gretzky, Coffey, Curry that get the recognition, not Grandfjord.
Okay, right now let's go to the ice to Tom Meese and Grandfjord. Tom?
Stores for sponsoring it. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm with Grant Fuhr here on the ice. Grant, just thanking the fans here of Hartford. Grant, there's got to be a thrill for you, even though your team did not win the All-Star game, to get the MVP award.
It's nice. I mean, we've played four All-Star games. I haven't won one yet, so. But it's great. I mean, you're just out here having fun, seeing what you can do, and I'm just glad to win it.
Off the top of my head, you're the first goalie since Mike Liu to win the MVP.
It doesn't happen very often. I mean, it's not a defensive game, but I just got lucky tonight.
All right, Grant Fuhr of the Edmonton Oilers. Congratulations, Grant.
Thank you.
Okay, Grant Fuhr of the Edmonton Oilers, the MVP of the 38th NHL All-Star Game. A mighty happy man, and he's one car richer.
Thank you, Tom. Mickey Redman, not a bad-looking car for Grant Fuhr to drive around.
I'll tell you what, I love the smile on Grant Fuhr. That's great to see. I thought that he certainly deserved it the way he played the first 30 minutes. That's a beautiful car, and I know Grant Fuhr is going to enjoy it, and I'm glad for him. He's a nice young man.
I think after the first period started rather slowly, the game tended opened up in the second half of the second period, and then late in the third period, the goals started to come.
Thank goodness for that. I think they really did. They were very tentative. They're trying to make the perfect play, the pretty play. And as the game did progress, the second period, third period, we got more intensity, really, a couple of hits. And in the overtime, I noticed they were really trying to open it up and end it. So, you know, not a bad All-Star game. You don't get cup films to save usually from All-Star games, but they saved it in the third period.
Glenn Sather's still looking for his first win, John Davidson.
And he's going to downplay it and say, oh, what are you going to do? Just a nice, fun event. But you saw the emotion when they showed the tying goal when I believe it was Hawerchuk scored it. There was the emotion with Glenn Sather, and he's a good guy. The thing is, good for him. He wins all the time with the Edmonton Oilers. Humble him a little bit, huh, guys?
And it turned out to be a rather exciting game down the stretch.
It was. It was good. Bob Froese made a big save on Gretzky before they scored that overtime goal. You have to remember that. Good save at one end, set something up at the other end for Grant Fuhr. His wife couldn't make the game. She's expecting. She's back in Edmonton. Got a real nice family present. Brand new car.
Great working with John Davidson and Mickey Redman. This is Sam Rosen. Right now, let's go to Jim Kelly.
All right, Sam, a great job all the way around. Thank you very much, and welcome back, everybody. Only the second overtime game in the history of the All-Star Game in the National Hockey League. It has been a dandy here in Hartford. Speaking of great games, another dandy coming right up on tape delay. Number one-ranked North Carolina against second-ranked Georgia Tech. I won't give away the winner, but I will tell you this. It went right down to the wire, and it was a buzzer beater. So, for all of us here at ESPN, our play-by-play man, Sam Rosen, and our expert analyst, John Davidson, along with Mickey Redman, Tom Meese has been roving the stands with the celebrities. I'm Jim Kelly, thanking everybody, especially, of course, Mr. Howard Baldwin, the chairman of the Hartford Whalers, and Mr. John Ziegler in the National Hockey League. Final score once again in overtime, the Wales Conference 4, the Campbell's Conference 3. 3 days of heroes and hype and hoopla has come to a close. Let's take a final look back now at the 1986 All-Star Game and Week.